And Chris, the first Saturday of the 2010 college football season just seconds away as we welcome you to a presentation of the SEC on ESPN. College football presented by Cars.com. The post-Tim Tebow era begins here in Gainesville. First time the Gators will play without the iconic Tebow since 2005 as they welcome Miami, Ohio to Ben Hill Griffin Stadium. Along with Bob Greasy, Chris Spielman, and Quint Kestnick down on the field, I'm Dave Pack. Urban Meyer entering his sixth season as the head coach here at Florida. A lot of people were unsure back in late December whether he would coach a sixth season after he retired, and then the next day announced that he would instead take a leave of absence. He's back, manning the sideline for the Gators, who will kick off to Miami. Caleb Sturgis to boot it away. DeMarco Payne, Luke Swift are back. We're underway. The opening college football Saturday of September. It's DeMarco Payne for the Red Hawks. And Payne with a good return out near the 30. Knocked out at the 29. So Urban Meyer back in December 26th announced that he would retire the next day. Instead said a leave of absence. They did not find out until January that it was esophageal spasms. He thought initially it might be a heart issue. He was back March 17th. Said he's recruiting a little bit less, working out a little bit more, and eating better.
I think it was just a scare when he found out it wasn't as serious that he came back. And Chris, what not to come back to? Well, who would want to leave this job?
Florida 13-1 record a year ago. Miami was 1-11. Here's their quarterback, Zach Dicer, dumping it off to Merriweather. Good play on first down. And his helmet ripped off by Justin Tratto out near the first down marker.
Zach Dicer, I had a chance to speak with Zach before the game, and he's relaxed and excited about his opportunity. And when you play a speed defense, boys, one way to slow them down, screens and draws and get rid of the ball quickly. And that's Miami's game plan under Mo Watts and Mike Haywood coming into the swamp. Slow them down by the quick pass and screens, just like they opened the game with. Outstanding call.
9-yard pickup. Dicer, the sophomore, started 9 games last year. Had a terrific performance against Temple. Threw for over 400 yards. Merriweather knocked down, but appears to have the first down. Ahmad Black made the stop. Take a look at Miami's starting offense. Got a young offensive line. Welcome to Major College Football, Josh Harvey. Right tackle, a freshman going up against those outstanding pass rushers for Florida. And the skill players, Armand Robinson is Miami's best at 67 catches a year ago. Miami got to find a way to run the ball. Merriweather led the team last year with 291 yards from Mike Haywood in his second season as the head coach, coming over from Notre Dame, where he was the offensive coordinator for Charlie Weiss. Dicer looking and dumping it off to Jamal Rogers, who's dropped in the backfield for a loss by Ahmad Black. The defensive starters for Florida, returning 5 starters. They lost 5 guys to the NFL, all drafted in the first 3 rounds. Tratto and Lemons at the end positions, Hunter and Howard in the middle. And the linebackers, as usual, very fast with A.J. Jones, Bostic, and Brandon Hicks.
They also lost their offensive coordinator, Charlie Strong, who went on, who's now the head coach at Louisville.
And Terrell Austin, coming over from the NFL, was the DB's coach with the Cardinals in his first year as the defensive coordinator, replacing Strong. SEC officials today. Matt Austin, our referee.
Dead ball, delay of game, number 4 offense. 5-yard penalty, still sucking out.
When you start that many young players and you go ahead and try to change formations and personnel groupings, that happens often early in the season and early in the ball game, especially in the swamp, where a lot of these kids aren't used to coming and playing in this type of venue. But they do have a good leader pulling the trigger, Zach Dicer. Get him settled down. Second and long. Watch out, boys. Here comes a screen or a draw.
Dicer on 2nd and 19. Finds Merriweather. And he's got running room. He gets clocked. Big hit by Jelani Jenkins. Cut back to the original line of scrimmage. Ahmad Black helping out on the tackle as well.
You call it, it's a little slip screen. He's got speed, but that speed of the Gators just caught up with him.
I'll tell you what he did. Now, he was the hitter. Now, Jenkins came in there and put a nice shot on him, but Jenkins forgot to bring his arms and wrap him up, and it would have been a great tackle as opposed to Haywood running through, a great shot. You're going for the highlight film as opposed to going for the sure tackle. Haywood just put him on his highlight film for the year. There you go. Get it started, boys.
Florida had the number 4 defense in college football a year ago. Jay Howard takes down the quarterback, Dysert, for a sack at the 32. Four starts a year ago for Jay Howard. Coaches say he needs to finish more. He did here.
Yeah, you see there, number 6, Jay Howard, hit him with a quick swim, and all that is he takes his right arm, throws it up in the air, gets his body tilted, and beats the offensive lineman, Nate Williams, with half a man.
I don't like defensive lineman number 6. I mean, he's a big guy, 300 pounds. He needs a 90 number, right?
I think he could put 3 numbers on his back and it still fit.
Yeah.
They're going to try to kick it away from Rainey, and that hit a Gator. It hit Matt Elam, and instead of falling on it initially, he tried to get out of the way. The ball bounced off of him, but he still recovered it. They do not want to kick it deep to Rainey. Instead, they almost had it blocked.
You try the rugby-style kick right here. The problem is Florida read their mail, and everybody slanted toward the side of the rugby kick. They gave it away.
Well, we were talking to Urban yesterday, and he said, we put our best athletes on punt block. Now, we're going to get one of them. Miami, on the other side, had a first-time snapper and a first-time punter.
If I'm Brantley, throw deep. Take a shot at the end zone. First one out of the get-go.
Instead, a run play to Rainey, who's playing Percy Harvin's old position. Dragged down after a gain of a couple by Ryan Kennedy. First start for John Brantley. Tebow's back up the last 3 years. Played in 17 career games prior to today. He says, I'm just a regular dude from Ocala. One of the nutritionists actually thought he was a swimmer. Says he walks around campus, nobody really knows who he is. A little bit different than the guy who played that position the last few years here.
I don't know if you take that as a compliment or an insult.
I think
you look like a swimmer to me, Dave. Right?
I think he loves walking around campus, not being noticed.
Here's Demps, and not much. Good defense by Deion Nunley, a true freshman, tackling Demps, starting at running back. We talked about Rainey, who's moved from running back to that slot receiver position that Percy Harvin played a couple of years ago, leading Florida to a title.
You know, I know it's early, boys, but again, you have such a speed advantage over this Miami defense. Young guys, go ahead and toss the rock down the field, and it just puts a little scare in them. Then you can come back to your short stuff.
You played defense, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
And a bad snap. Brantley hustling. Can't fall on it.
Pick it up. Attaboy. Now don't fall.
Miami's got it inside the 25-yard line. Pat Hinkle scooping it up for the Redhawks.
Wasn't even looking for the ball. He snapped it early, it looked like. Then Brantley couldn't get on it. That could have been a touchdown for Miami if he could have kept his feet. Noticed this in practice the other day. Yeah, the snaps were low. Pouncey, playing center for the first time this year, had a lot of low snaps in practice the other day.
Yeah, Mike Pouncey replacing Marquise, his twin brother, who's off to the NFL. First round pick of the Steelers. Mike Pouncey was a guard last year. Now playing center. Miami ball inside the Florida 25. Dysert's pass caught by Jamal Rogers near the 21. Janoris Jenkins on the cover.
It's a nice job. Again, the philosophy of Miami and Mo Watts, the offensive coordinator coming into this game, is the quick passing game. Catch and throw, catch and throw. Why? You're not going to be able to hold this pass rush out. And also, man-to-man, you have difficulty matching up with their defensive backs. So you hit him with a quick game. Hopefully you bust a tackle and make a play. But it does slow down an aggressive defense.
Morris Watts in his second year as the offensive coordinator. Prior to that, he was fishing and hunting for 5 years. Movement up front and a fly down.
the snap, false start. 82 offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Florida had a nice little corner blitz with Janoris Jenkins sneaking in there, kind of 007 style. Now he might have been in a neutral zone, although Miami snapped it earlier.
Wait a minute now. Sneaking in, 007. Yeah. He's in midseason form.
I mean, that's what I thought of just at that very second of time.
Yeah, you know what movies Chris watched last night in preparation for the game?
Yeah, in the offseason.
I could have went Inspector Gadget on you, but nobody would get that.
Oh, boy.
And now Miami, Ohio calls a timeout. Already one delay of game, and they were close on getting a second violation instead of timeout.
Gordon Gekko was one of the biggest names on Wall Street before he went to prison.
Gekko, my name is Jacob Moore. I'm going to marry your daughter.
I think you're going to be part of the family business. It's easy to get in. It's hard to get out.
Is that a threat?
Absolutely.
He's not who you think he is. He'll hurt us.
I'm going to destroy Gekko.
Do I hear revenge here?
I'm about to serve it up hot.
Is that a threat?
Absolutely.
Wall Street money never sleeps. Rated PG-13.
We go to Olive Garden all the time. So sure, I already knew the salad and breadsticks were endless. But the other night, even the pasta was endless.
The never-ending pasta bowl with new sauces like our hearty Chianti 3 meat. Choose all the sauce and pasta combinations you want for just $8.95 at Olive Garden.
I'm a Wrangler guy. Always have been, always will be. I was wearing Wranglers long before I went pro. And I've stuck with them ever since. They just fit the way jeans should fit. Relaxed and comfortable. That's my Wrangler story. What's yours?
Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans.
I gotta say, nothing beats Wrangler comfort.
For long-lasting comfort, the right choice is Wrangler.
Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
Fastest mobile broadband network, AT&T. Rethink possible.
Hey, man. You coming to the draft tomorrow, right?
Of course. I'm the only one that knows how to pick a team around here.
Didn't you lose last year?
I can't be held responsible for that. Besides, this year, I'm going to sit back and let the draft come to me.
All right, you're up again.
Hang on. I got another scout calling in from Europe.
Go, Rodrigo.
What happened with just letting the draft come to you?
ESPN Fantasy Football. Sign up today at ESPN.com.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
This is Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week.
Terrific opening weekend of college football starting today in Gainesville. Merriweather hit at the point of attack by Jonathan Bostic and Omar Hunter. It'll bring up third down and long. Many of you wondering, if you just tuned in, why does Miami have the ball inside the Florida 30? That's because of a turnover on a bad snap that rolled past John Brantley about 20 yards. Brantley making his first start at quarterback for Florida.
One of the concerns for Mike Haywood was that he would come down here and turn it over early and give Florida an early advantage on the scoreboard. But this is ideal. This, if you wanted to have something happen, this is what you want for Miami.
Dysert finds an open man inside the 20 and about a yard short of the first down marker. Is Armon Robinson. They say that he stepped out at the 16, so it'll be 4th and 2. Dysert 5 for 5 passing so far.
Good matchup and a read by Dysert with Robinson working one-on-one with Matt Elam. He's going to come across the middle right here, and Robinson just with the speed beats Matt Elam. We talk about guys getting used to the speed. Elam, a true freshman, needs to get used to the game speed.
Trevor Cook last year was 7 of 12 on field goal tries. He opens the season with a 33-yard attempt. And Miami, Ohio, has the lead. Don't know if that's the last time we'll say that, but it's the Redhawks with the early advantage on the road in Gainesville.
From an early age, Timothy Richmond understood that with knowledge comes confidence. In junior high, while abroad, he explained how jellyfish stings can be neutralized with vinegar. In perfect Italian. As an adult, Timothy's knowledge of storm cells and tornadoes saved the Newbury Prep cheerleading squad. But when it came time to buy a new car, he was just as nervous as the rest of us. So Timothy got his knowledge at cars.com, regained his confidence, and got the perfect car at the perfect price.
Ndamukong Suh, why are we hiding behind this display?
Shh. Not hiding. Hunting.
What are we hunting?
Quarterback.
Why are we only wearing Nike Pro Hyperstrong?
The hunter only brings what he needs for the hunt.
Nike Pro Combat Hyperstrong, available at Dick's Sporting Goods. Better athlete, better team.
I don't know about this.
Bro, you can't chicken out now.
Yeah, can't do it. It's really high. Look at that boat down there.
Those guys have a ton of Bud Light.
Here we go. Oh! Check it out. Oh, aluminum bottles, anyone? Double edge, they're a little salty.
It's the sure sign of a good time. The just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
She wants it back.
What side are you on?
The American. Rated R.
With a new Build Your Own Omelette from Denny's, you can make your own omelette any way you like. Like spinach, tomatoes, and pepper jack cheese. Or Swiss cheese, ham, and jalapeno peppers. Or bacon, avocado, cheddar cheese, pico de gallo, prime rib, fire roasted peppers and onions, chorizo, American cheese, sausage.
ESPN's College Football is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard. And in part by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Welcome back to Gainesville. You know, last year, Florida didn't trail until October 17th. That was game number six against Arkansas. And here they are, midway through the first quarter, their first game of 2010, down to a MAC school that had one win a year ago. Now, let's not get carried away. Got a long way to go, but still a good start for Miami. And if you're Florida quarterback John Brantley taking over for Tim Tebow, he told us yesterday he was going to be nervous. Certainly had some pressure now after a rough start.
Urban's getting that stress test quite early, isn't he? See how his health is.
Kick popped up and taken at the 30-yard line by Gillis Lee. And he's across the 40 as we go back to the studio and say hello to Reese Davis.
Hello, gentlemen. For the first of many times this year, a Taco Bell studio update. Remember last year in the early season, second week, Michigan State struggled with an in-state rival, Central Michigan. Old Edwin Baker's trying to make sure it doesn't happen against Western Michigan on ESPN2. Sparty up 7-0 in the first.
Good week so far for the Big Ten. Minnesota winning the other night. Ohio State, number two in the country with a big win. Florida ranked fourth. After a 13-win season a year ago, including a victory in the Sugar Bowl. Florida turned it over on its first possession. Brantley in shotgun here. Brantley with the late pitch to Rainey. Knocked out of bounds after a gain of about 4 yards. Pat Hinkle on the stop.
And there was a little bit of an option, Chris. And we were, you know, the first thing that Carl Reese, the defensive coordinator, said for Miami, says, do they still run the option? We got to prepare for the option. Well, yes, they do, but they're not going to run the option like they ran it with with Tim Tebow. We're going to run it with Brantley getting rid of the ball to this fast little guys. We asked John yesterday. He says, I'm getting rid of it. Let those little guys run with it.
Another low snap. Brantley scoops this one up and hits Rainey out in the flat. Gets only a couple. Brought down by Hinkle again. Let's check in with Quint down on the field.
Dave, a big concern for Miami head coach Mike Haywood was this environment. He's playing about 34 freshmen and sophomores. He was concerned that the guys would get overwhelmed. But this is a team that so far is embracing this environment. They're actually drawing upon the electricity that's here. And actually after kicking that last field goal, it's very much a business as usual approach on the Miami sideline.
Well, Dicer looked pretty calm for Miami as Brantley finds Demps out of the backfield near the first down marker. Deion Nunley made the tackle. Let's see where they spot it.
Good job by Hines, the tight end, working out and blocking Nunley to allow Demps to use his speed to get up to the first down. Nunley could not get off the block of Hines and force that ball back inside to the pursuit. You want to play for Florida and you're a wide receiver, you better be able to block. You see Hines right there pushing Nunley long enough and holding his position to force Demps to get the first down.
They're short, and Florida will go for it. Wow. Fourth down and inches. You're surprised, Chris.
Yeah, that spot.
Emmanuel Moody is the deep man. And Moody gonna come up short. There's a flag down, though, on the far side. Jordan Gafford, two-time co-captain, made the hit. Florida players are saying it's against Miami. Boy, you come up with a stop on fourth down and you're offside.
Yep.
Now they're marking it off, so it's going to be a Florida first down. That would essentially have been two turnovers and two possessions for Florida. Instead, it's a first down.
Offside, 36 defense. That's a five-yard penalty, which results in a first down. There was also a flag thrown for illegal participation, but the defense was legal with only 11 players. Therefore, there is no foul. First down.
Luke Kelly lined up in the neutral zone.
That's a killer for Miami, too, because they had him stopped.
Yep.
Here's Brantley off play action. Going to air it out. Going for Deontay Thompson. Can't hang on. D.J. Brown on the coverage.
What a great throw by Brantley. The first big time throw down the field. Hit Thompson right there. And the defensive back just knocks it away.
See, right here, I would have done this the first or second play. D.J. Brown does a good job of not quitting on the play and playing the receiver's hands. That's beautiful. And not panicking, trusting your training, trusting your technique. He had him, but D.J. Brown not quitting and doing a good job of executing the technique of playing the hands and not the ball. Man, I get excited about that, Greece.
He's throwing his arms over here. I got to move away.
Brantley to Rainey, and again, good defense. Ball out, recovered by Miami. Austin Brown recovers it, the second turnover by Florida.
Florida has had two possessions, and they've turned it over the first two times they've had it.
You could actually say they turned it over three times because of not picking up fourth down, but a Miami penalty kept the Florida drive alive. Do you think he caught it there, guys? Did he have possession?
Take a look right here. There's the ball making a football move. Ryan Kennedy by defeating the blocker one-on-one, trying to make a tackle, and yet having the knowledge to go ahead and try to keep stripping that football. Now, Florida's got to wake up. You know, quit playing around. Understand who you are and what you are. And Miami's got to go and capitalize on this field position because field position doesn't come easily against a team like Florida.
On the 47, Dysart, who's 5 for 5 passing, going to run here and takes a shot and doesn't get much. Janoris Jenkins coming up to greet him. College football season in mid-season form with a BCS buster in week one. Andy Dalton and TCU taking on Oregon State tonight. College football primetime presented by Hampton Hotels, part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week.
Now, Janoris Jenkins got shaken up a little bit there. Dysart's a big guy now. You look at his shoulder. I think he got a stinger. Now, if he's thinking about that injury, if they got guys in the box up here, if you got some type of play, go after him. Go after him right now.
And remember, Jeremy Brown has battled an ankle injury this week in practice. There you see the shot. Jenkins at 185 pounds against a 215-pound quarterback in Dicer. Dicer finds Merriweather out of the backfield for a gain of a couple. There's a flag down. Jonathan Bostic on the stop for Florida.
Now
Miami penalty. That's four already for Mike Haywood's squad.
Illegal formation on the offense. 5 men in the backfield. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
What has been the most surprising, other than the turnovers, most surprising part of this start here for Florida?
I think for Florida is the fact that they've turned the ball over twice.
Other than that, what would you say? Is it the fact they really haven't gotten a lot of pressure on Dicer other than the one time?
You know what I say? I say everybody's talking about the speed that Florida had over Miami, and Miami has to get used to the game speed. Well, I'm saying this. Florida's offense is not used to the Miami defense game speed. That's when Miami's beating them to the punch, and they're playing faster than the Florida offense on defense.
Never thought I'd hear you say those words. Dicer with another good throw. Finds Chris Gibbons, about 5 yards short of a first down. Here's Reese.
Dave, last year, Iowa escaped on opening day. A couple of late blocked field goals against Northern Iowa, against Eastern Illinois. Adam Robinson, who set a Hawkeye freshman record with over 800 yards rushing last year, has a couple of touchdowns already. Penn State starting freshman quarterback Robert Bolden, aided by a couple of penalties on their field goal drive to go up on Youngstown State.
You know, Reese, some of our experts picked Iowa to play for the national championship. You guys buying that?
I like Iowa, but I don't. They're not that strong.
Dicer in trouble. Gets away from a defender and throws an interception. Bostic picks it off.
Miami led the nations in giveaways last year. Zach Dicer had been doing a nice job of controlling the ball game and not turning it over. This could turn the whole momentum around to the Gators right here.
You're watching ESPN, new home of the Bowl Championship Series.
Saturday Night Football on ABC, LSU North Carolina, tonight at 8 Eastern.
Hey, what's going on?
Doing the shipping.
Man, it would be a lot easier if we didn't have to weigh them all.
If those boxes are under 70 pounds, you don't have to weigh them. With these Priority Mail flat rate boxes from the Postal Service, if it fits, it ships anywhere in the country for a low flat rate.
No way.
Nope.
No way?
Yeah.
No way.
Sure.
No way?
Uh-uh.
No way.
Yes way, no way.
Priority Mail flat rate box shipping starts at $4.95, only from the Postal Service. A simpler way to ship.
Momentum. It's like a rolling ball of thunder that takes on a character all its own. No one knows exactly how you get it. But once you have it, you drive like the devil to keep it. And tomorrow night, when momentum comes to town, it'll be harder than nails to stop.
The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Atlanta, tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN. Telecast presented by Pennzoil.
Is your computer running slowly? Thinking about buying a new one? Don't waste your money. Your computer could be infected with spyware, malware, viruses, or you could be experiencing registry errors, spam, and pop-ups. With new technology, you no longer need a technician to come to your home or drop your computer at some store. Get a free diagnosis at MaxMySpeed.com and find out in minutes what's slowing down your computer.
They were able to diagnose it and solve our problem. It's at least 100% to 150% quicker than before.
My computer runs twice as fast.
The computer has run so much quicker. It's safer, it's faster, it's more secure.
My computer is 100% faster than it was prior. All I could say is I'm a raving fan. This is unbelievable.
Go to MaxMySpeed.com right now for your free diagnosis and find out in minutes what's slowing down your computer. That's MaxMySpeed.com for your free diagnosis.
Welcome back to College Football on ESPN, presented by Cars.com.
Welcome back to Gainesville. We've had a grand total of 2 first downs and 3 turnovers. The latest by Miami of Ohio to put Florida and its offense back on the field for the third time. From the 41, Brantley will hand it off to Demps. No running room. Dragged down by Jarrell Wedge. Guys, you're Urban Meyer and Steve Adazio, the offensive coordinator. How do you help your quarterback, John Brantley, here, given the fact that Florida's turned it over twice already?
Patience.
Just be patient. Everything's going to be all right. This is the first two possessions of the Brantley era. Just be patient. Things are going to be all right.
All right, let's throw the ball over there. Don't be patient. Throwing the ball down the field. I watch a spring game. I watch practice. The ball never hit the ground. Let them toss the rock. Now they're going all old school with him under center in the I formation.
Another run play to the opposite side. This time Demps has a lane, but it closes at the 45, and he fumbled it again. But it's recovered by Carl Moore.
Well, you've seen what Steve Adazio has called. The first two plays of this possession are I formation runs. He's going to try and run the football.
Steve Adazio, yeah. The assistant head coach and offensive coordinator.
An interesting chat with him yesterday. It was he was the guy that stepped in for Urban Meyer when Urban was a little retired there for a second.
Brantley unloads a strike to Deontay Thompson for a Florida first down to the 46. Let's check in with Quinn.
Dave, Steve Adazio told us last year in the shotgun about 99 to 98% with Tebow. This year about 70 to 75% shotgun. You'll see more eye, more direct handoffs. You will see some option, but the focus there will be on the give to the fullback or the pitch and not a quarterback run.
Brantley underneath to Rainey, makes some nifty moves, and then down at the 38-yard line, a gain of about 7. Tonight, ABC delivers a key game for two programs looking to get the season started on the winning track. Les Miles and LSU against a depleted North Carolina team in the Chick-fil-A kickoff game. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines, part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week on ABC. Another low snap. Brantley gathers and throws high, intended for Carl Moore.
You know, there hasn't been a snap that Brantley has not had to work for. Now, if you get a good snap, so Carl Moore shaking up on the play. If you get a good snap, you can get your eyes down the field quickly, Bob. Start reading defenses. If that snap from a shotgun position is something that you have to work for, what that does is it takes that few seconds of your eyes off downfield because you're looking for the football. Now, they're batting about 8% to 5% on good snaps. I'll get the direct number for you from Joe here in a minute. There again, he's working to get the ball, and his eyes can't go down the field.
Then Mike Pouncey, Marquise's twin brother, moving over from guard to center. Marquise now in the NFL. Brantley facing pressure and hits true freshman Trey Burton, but he cannot hang on.
Short.
Got to give a little credit, too, guys, to the Miami defense. As soon as the ball gets there, they're either being hit or they're being tackled. Just as the ball gets there.
Now they're saying he caught it, but he's short. Ball came out at the end, but they ruled that he had it. They're measuring.
He makes a football move, and
looks like the ball was out before.
It's close, boys.
Mm-hmm. Ball looked like it came out on his way down, didn't it? The ground didn't cause it.
Nobody ran to the football though to recover it.
That's why
just in case.
The last short yardage play they ran, we had Jordan Gafford, young man from Worthington Kilborn High School in Columbus, Ohio, come off the corner and make a nice tackle. And schematically, it was the right defense. Now, what they, you see they're short by about a half a yard.
Well, they went earlier and didn't get it, but because of our Miami offside penalty, they were given the first down. Looks like the Gators are going to go. Yeah.
If they go with an eye this time, they're going to probably run behind the lead back. They tried to run without the lead back last time. That didn't get him nothing but a lost yard. Now, if you run with the lead back, at least you give Moody another chance to knock off the free man.
It's old-time football. Eye formation, run behind, power football.
They forget how to do that nowadays, Bob.
Well, I know.
Bring back Zonk and kick, man. Let's go.
And guys, with Tebow, a lot of times this is where he would thrive. You'd just run him.
Yeah. Exactly.
In a short yardage situation.
Yeah, exactly.
Didn't work against Ole Miss a couple years ago, right? Was that the team where they stopped old Tim on the 4th and 1?
Go offset eye.
Run to the right.
And a pitch. Moody can't handle it. Miami takes over on downs. Evan Harris chasing down Moody.
It's not a Brantley thing. It's not a Moody thing. It's not a Thompson thing. It's the whole team that is infected with whatever they've got. They just came out here not ready to play. University of Florida.
They're infected with the dropsies. I mean, they're used to working this type of humidity and this type of football. Miami's not dropping the ball and putting it on the ground. They're dropping. Everybody's dropping the ball.
But you're Florida. Why not just line up and pound it? You got to get 2 inches.
That. They just tried that. I formation, the first two plays of that formation were line up I and pound the football.
Play fake for Dysart. He's going deep. And a pass off the mark. It was intended for Jamal Rogers, who got tangled up with Janoris Jenkins.
You like to call Greece after a turnover?
Yeah,
take
I like
a shot.
It. I like it. You know, and I like what Miami is doing. I was talking with Morris Watts, the coordinator for the offense for Miami, on the field before the ball game, and he says, I just want us to get into the ball game, not turn the ball over, not help Florida any at all. And I think his game has started off pretty well for old Morris Watts. He's a good guy, been around for a long time.
41st year as a college or professional coach. Dice are trying to set up the screen, and it's incomplete. Intended for Thomas Merriweather. That's the end of the first quarter. Miami, Ohio. Not Miami, Florida. Miami, Ohio leading Florida 3-0 after one.
Game two of the Western Conference Finals, Seattle versus Phoenix, Sunday at 3 on ABC.
Every day, it's getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day, it's getting faster.
AT&T and BlackBerry teamed up to evolve the smartphone. Business, meet fun. Fun, business. AT&T. Rethink possible.
Thanks to the Venture Card from Capital One, we get double miles on every purchase. So we earned an LA getaway twice as fast. We get double miles every time we use our card, no matter what we're buying. And since double miles add up quick...
Roman!
Get up! We can bring the whole gang. It's hard to beat double miles.
Whoa. He's on the list.
But we're with him.
Introducing the Venture Card from Capital One. With double miles on every purchase every day. Go to CapitalOne.com.
What's in your wallet?
This is the jungle. Disguised as a wedding, but a jungle nonetheless. And here there are two types of tigers. One that goes straight to the prey. And the one who makes the prey surrender to him. There once was a hungry road that wouldn't let drivers get very far. It wore out their tires, forcing them to buy new ones time and time again. Then along came the Michelin man who proved the right tire changes everything. And with long-lasting tires in place, those drivers were back on the road to saving money. Michelin Hydro-Edge tires last up to 33,000 miles longer. Michelin, a better way forward.
Bursting with mouth-watering real fruit and refreshingly blended with creamy low-fat yogurt, McDonald's new strawberry banana and wild berry smoothies are 100% pure sipping fun. The simple joy of real fruit smoothies.
You're watching ESPN.
Welcome back to Gainesville. One quarter in the books. Miami, Ohio on top of Florida, the fourth-ranked team in the nation. 3-0 in the first game of the post-Tim Tebow era. It has not gone well for Florida's offense. They have minus 28 yards rushing, and most of that coming on fumbles. Pass is dropped. And ruled incomplete. Ahmad Black thought he had an interception. It hit Armand Robinson right in the hands for Miami, but he could not hang on in his fourth down.
And they come with a zone pressure right here off the corner. And the ball does bounce into Black's hands.
Timeout, Florida. The first time out of the half.
Ahmad was just trying to steal one there, trying to convince the side judge that I really caught the ball.
Florida calls a timeout. The Gator offense on the field when we come back.
There's no way to hide it. If you drive drunk, we will find you. Cops everywhere are stepping up enforcement and cracking down like never before.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight? Sir, have you been drinking this evening?
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Make no mistake, you will get caught and you will be arrested. Over the limit, under arrest.
Introducing the new Big Italy Pizza from Pizza Hut. Bigger than two medium pizzas, it's 18 slices of hand-stretched crust with up to three of your favorite toppings, all for just $12. And for a limited time, get a free 2-liter Pepsi Max when you buy any 2-liter Pepsi, only at your Pizza Hut.
New York, great city, and you must respect, especially the football giants. But now with DirecTV, people can watch Cowboys game on phone in New York.
Touchdown! Touchdown!
We are here.
This is Central Park.
Only DirecTV lets you watch your game wherever you go. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Every day, I'm fighting. Sometimes against an opponent. Sometimes against myself. But I'm not afraid. Lugs. Built for the streets.
Professionals need to perform under pressure. And pressure can cause anyone's deodorant to fail. Introducing Gillette Odor Shield Antiperspirant. Unlike regular deodorants, it targets and neutralizes odor at the source. Help eliminate odor. Don't just cover it up. Gillette Odor Shield Antiperspirant. Also try Odor Shield technology and new body wash.
3-0 Miami, Ohio on top of Florida. Dave Patch along with Bob Greasy, Chris Spielman, and Quint Kesnick here in Gainesville. Fourth down, and for the second time, Ryan Kennedy, who's a linebacker, is in there to punt. He's a rugby-style punter, and it's going to be a fake, trying to set up a play to Bruton, who makes a heck of a catch, and it's a first down for Miami. How did he catch that football?
Unbelievable. He's not the punter, and he's not the quarterback, but he just threw a pass from midfield.
Lorenzo Edwards was all over Kendrick Bruton, who had one catch all of last year.
Kennedy is a linebacker. He made a great catch, and I'm just saying, Chris, by that number five, he probably was a quarterback in high school.
Looked like a Bob Greasy jump pass to me.
First down at the 37 of Florida. Big hit by Janoris Jenkins. Lost his lid as he came up and wrapped up Thomas Merriweather for a loss on the play.
Nice little aggressive play call by Coach Austin with the corner blitz. You see Jenkins coming off unblocked. No shot. And a good job of Hayward actually securing that football. Jenkins playing without your helmet.
It's all right.
Not the smartest thing, but I did it too.
Yeah, we can tell.
Yeah, really. You're shocking, isn't it?
You did it on purpose. That's the difference. Florida's had the ball for only 6 minutes today because of the two turnovers. They have minus 9 yards of total offense.
Three possessions Florida has had, and two of them ended in turnovers.
And a timeout called by Miami, avoiding another delay of game.
Timeout. Miami University. Their second time out of the half.
Second time they've had to burn a timeout because the play clock was winding down. Meanwhile, let's check in with Reese Davis back in the studio.
All right, guys, Gators aren't the only big-name team struggling with a so-called lesser opponent. Penn State at home against Youngstown State in the football championship subdivision. Kurt Hess finds Dominique Barnes, and Barnes is going to house it. The Penguins have the lead on the Nittany Lions. His heels to the field is the senior from Southfield, Michigan. Penn State has answered with another field goal at 7-6.
Reese and here in Gainesville, but Miami with the lead thanks to miscues by Florida's offense.
Low snap by the center, Pouncey.
Recovered by Hinkle, and here's the fumble after the catch by Rainey. And then Moody just unable to handle the pitch.
Yeah, everybody's involved. You know, Thompson has dropped one. Rainey has had a fumble. Pouncey, the center, has made several bad snaps. So, you know, it's not one guy. It's the whole team.
You saw that five times the ball's hit the ground. And that last one by Moody was on fourth down. All kinds of movement up front. Miami can't stay onside. Four penalties by the Redhawks already.
The freshman Josh Harvey got a little jumpy now. Somebody came in and at least had movement across from him, which forced the big fella to stand up and flinch.
Prior to the snap, offsides, six defense, entering the neutral zone, causing the offense to fall start. It's a 5-yard penalty, still second down.
First penalty on Florida today. On ABC tonight, Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines, part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week. North Carolina minus 13 players taking on LSU. Chris, you and I saw North Carolina's spring game. They got a lot of talent, but they will not be available in Atlanta tonight. Can they still win?
Well, absolutely, I think they can still win. It's certainly more difficult.
Dicer throws an interception. Janoris Jenkins taking it the other way. Interception return for a touchdown by Janoris Jenkins for Florida's first score.
It's a bad read by Zach Dysart. They had a zone pressure from coming from the top of the screen, so that's where you throw the quick game. You don't throw it away from the zone pressure because Jenkins was sitting there baiting him. Gator baiting him.
I like that. Gator baiting him.
Went after by Caleb Sturgis. 7-3 Florida. Janoris Jenkins, 3-year starter. Joe Hayden's gone to the NFL with the Browns. Jenkins saying it's my turn to impress the nation. An interception return for a touchdown, 70 yards, and Florida leads for the first time.
We're the Lunds, and our family has owned 5 Camrys.
I drove the 92 Camry.
I drive a 2007 Camry.
I was expecting the 2005 Camry, and my sister got it.
I was driving the 94 Toyota Camry, and my dad surprised me with a 2005 Toyota Camry.
I drove all of them, but I drive the 2009.
Why Camry?
Reliability, yeah. Affordability.
Share your Toyota story on Facebook.com/Toyota.
Folks, welcome to the neighborhood, where Applebee's 2 for 20 is better than ever this season. More from the sideline.
That's right, Boomer. Applebee's 2 for 20 is stuffed with more flavor, like rich and tender Florentine ravioli with chicken and provolone stuffed meatballs, plus classics like the fire-grilled 7-ounce sirloin. One appetizer, two entrees, $20. Back to you, Boomer.
The best deal in the neighborhood just got better, and the Swami predicts total domination.
And there you have it.
There's no place like the neighborhood. Open until midnight or later.
Oh. Wow, that guy's really staring over here. Must have sold him some carpeting or something.
Mike, check out his bacon neck.
Bacon?
Sir, lean forward and show Michael Jordan your collar.
Oh.
See how it's all curled up like bacon in a pan? See how bad this dude looks?
What's that?
Thank you.
Okay.
Not us, though, buddy. Our lay flats. We're like twins.
No, we're not.
Yeah, we are.
No, we're not.
Yeah.
Lay flat collar. Lays flat, won't bacon. Only from Hanes.
After battling the elements for 128 years, our wood stains can handle pretty much anything. Cabot, our performance is legendary.
ESPN's College Football, brought to you by Toyota and Applebee's. See what's new on Applebee's 2 for 20 menu. Classics you love and new flavors you'll crave.
2 years ago, the Gators led the nation in interception returns for touchdowns with five. They had three more last year. And their first score of 2010 is on an interception by Janoris Jenkins.
That might be what just shakes this team up and wakes them up in the 2010 season. Get them started.
Sturgis kickoff taken by DeMarco Payne, a transfer from Iowa. And he gets to the 21 and stood up there.
Take a look. Right here is the zone pressure is coming from the top of your screen. That means the short route will be open over here because he's playing deep down on this side. They're sitting on the little hitch route, and it's just catch. Watch Dysert's head. His head is looking right where he's going the whole time. An experienced, tough corner like Janoris Jenkins just runs. If he would look to the other side of the field, that's where the short route is open, the side of the zone blitz or the zone pressure.
And Jenkins is their best corner, All-American candidate. Dysert throwing another interception. The last two possessions, he's thrown two interceptions.
See how the sophomore responds on the road in Gainesville. On the 21, Merriweather trying to run right, and instead runs into Earl O'Connor. No gain, back to Reese.
All right, Dave, Western Michigan and Michigan State, the Broncos threatening. This is a fourth and goal play. Alex Carter would find Juan Nunez, and Western Michigan, all the way to Kalamazoo, they can hear it. They've tied it up against Sparty 7-7. Now, Iowa's up big on Eastern Illinois, but right now, as we're watching this game, Ricky Stanzi had his left leg buckle under him. They're checking him on the sideline. We'll keep you up to date.
Remember last year at home against Northwestern, Stanzi got hurt. Pass low, incomplete, intended for Jamal Rogers. It'll bring up third and long. Our Saturday menu brought to you by Applebee's. Coming up next on ESPN, Garrett Gilbert makes his first start, replacing Colt McCoy, Texas against Rice. And you see the games tonight, including on ESPN, TCU, Oregon State, and Carolina LSU over on ABC.
It's going to be interesting to see how Carolina reacts without all those defensive guys. They still got their quarterback. Top two running backs are out. But it's just going to be able to see how that game unfolds.
It's a chance for T.J. Yates to make a statement, be a star, win under adverse circumstances.
They got a number two that's pushing him, Bryn Renner, in Chapel Hill. Here's a draw play on third down and nine. And Merriweather cannot get away from true freshman Sharif Floyd. Well, we've talked about the games tonight. Here's a schedule for next week. Some huge games on ESPN, ESPN2, and ABC, including number two Ohio State, Miami, and Alabama, Penn State. Mark Ingram not playing tonight in their game with San Jose State. Don't know if he'll be available for that game next week against Penn State.
Bunch of block here.
And another fake. And throwing the football that time was Ryan Kennedy. Boy, Kennedy was back there with Zach Murphy, the normal punter this time. First time they've actually had the punter out on the field. How about that decision there?
You know what that tells me? Mike Haywood just going to go into this game and says, hey, we got no chance to win, very little chance. We're going to take every chance. We're going to take every gamble, every play, just see if we can win this ball game.
Why under 21, though?
hard thing. I was like the first person to leave home. My name is Ilan, and I'm saving up to buy a new Toyota Corolla. I really need the reliability that the Corolla provides. I am a bookkeeper and also a prep chef, so I need to be driving around from place to place. For the initial down payment, I'm 6 months out for when I get to go in and buy the Corolla and get the keys.
Share your Toyota story on Facebook.com/Toyota.
Freshly blended with creamy low-fat yogurt, McDonald's new strawberry banana and wild berry smoothies are 100% pure sipping fun. The simple joy of real fruit smoothies.
Smallville season 9 on Blu-ray and DVD. A villain from Krypton threatens Clark's powers.
I know my destiny.
You're about to learn what it feels like to get burned.
Packed with amazing extras. Smallville Season 9 on Blu-ray and DVD September 7th.
Patrick Willis, let's do this, player. 4.39. I've seen little children run faster than that. Let's do it again. Come on.
ABC's new fall show, Detroit 187. Get a peek at ABC.com.
Reese Davis with you in the studio. Georgia taking on Louisiana Lafayette. A.J. Green, by the way, being held out pending that investigation into the Asian party in South Florida. Caleb King into the end zone. First touchdown of the year for the Dogs. They're on the drive and on the move again, up 7-0.
Back here in Gainesville, it's 7-3. Florida on top. Miami going with the fake punt on fourth down from their own 21. And now Dempse to the outside, tripped up, couple of yards shy of a first down by DJ Brown.
Let's go back to the fake punt. This is why they threw the ball out there, because the receiver was uncovered. He's going to take the ball and throw it out there. But watch this guy right here. Florida knows what they're doing. The guy lines up as a linebacker, and then he's going to run back out for coverage. And that was not something that was called from the sideline. I mean, they give you the option to audible into that, and he did.
Another low snap. Bradley still able to get the handoff to Dempse, who has the first down of the 10-yard line.
Now, I don't know if sometimes that's not automatic. And why I think it maybe had been called from the sideline. He's taking all the shots because you look where Kennedy lined up. He lined up directly behind the center as a personal protector. If he wasn't going to throw the ball, then he would be off to his side. And you have a linebacker running a route, Bob, and you have a linebacker. Now, I know we're good athletes, but then you have a linebacker throwing.
Yeah.
But do the greasy jump pass.
Yeah. What I'm saying is it looked like it was there.
Yeah, it was there.
But the risk of it not working, I think, far outweighed the advantage of trying that play on that end of the field.
It was Matt Elam, by the way, number 22 for Florida.
Here's Dempse again, cut it back, and runs into a wall. Jarrell Wedge and Ryan Kennedy. In on the stop for Miami.
Look at Miami getting in the face of Dempse. Showing him a little toot. Watching, you see Wedge come up. There's one good hit. Ryan Kennedy finishing. The speed of the Red Hawk defense. Still surprising. Yeah, there's that toot. Go ahead, Jarrell.
This is a team that won one game last year.
Yeah.
Florida lost one game.
Their offense was near the bottom in the country, and their defense wasn't that good either.
Here's Brantley, shovel pass, and Dempse knocked down. First man to hit him was Luke Kelly, so third down and long coming up. They can get a first down before reaching the end zone.
There's that triple option where Brantley has the choice to pitch deep or to pitch short. And a nice job. Luke Kelly, number 36,
Remember in the past, they used to run that play last year with Hernandez, the tight end coming up and would catch the little ball and get some yardage with it.
Third down and nine. Ron Brantley, who broke Tim Tebow's state passing touchdown record here in Florida, making his first start. And finds an open man. It's Hines. Touchdown, Florida. There's Hernandez's replacement. At tight end, Omarius Hines with a touchdown.
And Greece and I were out of practice on Thursday in the red zone. Hines was a big player in practice. Brantley trusted him in the red zone in practice. He's going to trust him in the game in the red zone.
11th career touchdown pass by Brantley. First one as a starter in this post-Tebow era. And Florida, after that strange decision, whoever it was, coach or player, to try to fake the punt and give Florida the ball at Miami's 21-yard line. Brantley and the Gators make the Redhawks pay.
We're the Lunds, and our family has owned five Camrys.
I drove the 92 Camry.
I drive a 2007 Camry.
I was expecting the 2005 Camry, and my sister got it.
I was driving the 94 Toyota Camry, and my dad surprised me with a 2005 Toyota Camry.
I drove all of them, but I drive the 2009.
Why Camry?
Reliability, yeah. Affordability.
Share your Toyota story on Facebook.com/Toyota.
ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels, is back. If you're planning to hit the road to follow your team, stay at Hampton Hotels and enjoy a free hot breakfast and high-speed internet. Plus, if you search Hampton on ESPN.com, you can save up to 15% when booking at least 7 days in advance. And watch ESPN College Football Primetime.
Touchdown.
Saturday nights all season long on ESPN.
Every 60 seconds, someone, somewhere, is making the switch to Tempur-Pedic. Now, it's your turn. Call now for your free information kit, including a Tempur material sample, along with a DVD and catalog. Traditional mattresses use metal springs that can cause pressure points, causing you to toss and turn. Only the Tempur-Pedic mattress automatically adjusts to your body while keeping your spine in perfect alignment. Plus, because Tempur-Pedic doesn't transfer motion, you won't disturb your partner when you get out of bed or shift positions. Best of all, Tempur-Pedic will let you sleep on one of their sleep systems for an incredible 90 nights before you make your purchase decision. If you want the ultimate in comfort, if you wish to get more sleep but can't, it's time you make the switch to Tempur-Pedic. Call 1-800-346-2174 for your free information kit. That's 1-800-346-2174. Call today.
Urban Meyer's team with only 12 yards of total offense, but they lead it 14-3 thanks to Miami Ohio turnovers. John Brantley with the touchdown pass, his first as a starter since taking over for Tim Tebow. Sat behind Tebow the last 3 years. Marco Payne on the return for Miami. Out across the 25 and bumped out near the 27. We talked with Urban Meyer about the comparisons, Brantley versus Tebow.
When you cut them open, they're the same people. Very high character, very team-oriented, very competitive, very talented. One does it by pumping his fists and all this. The other one does it by calling the huddle tighter and talking to him. But at the end of the day, they're very similar people.
And obviously, guys, you cannot, quote, replace a guy like Tim Tebow, but there are a lot of people that think that in the end, John Brantley will be a better pure passing quarterback than Tebow, even though Tebow had great numbers as a passer in college and was a first-round draft pick. Dysart dumping it off. Merriweather can't hang on. Ruled incomplete. Here's Reese in the studio.
All right, Dave, things starting to take shape a little bit more now. Jimbo Fisher going out as head coach for the first time. Florida State against Samford. Samford's Jimbo's alma mater. Terrific quarterback there. Greg Reed led the nation in punt returns last year, but he only took one back for a touchdown. Now he's matched that total. Seminoles rolling. Ponder's been sharp. It's 28-0 early in the second.
Here it's 14-3, Reese. Dysart being chased by A.J. Jones and cannot complete it downfield. Intended for Gibbons. Janoris Jenkins, who had the INT for his score earlier, makes the play defensively. When you guys break down Brantley versus Tebow, you heard what Urban Meyer said. How do you guys view it?
Well, I don't think there's any doubt that John Brantley is a better, pure passer. However, when you look at quarterbacks, you know, Tebow had all those intangibles. He was a competitor. He was a winner. You know, and maybe Brantley will be that too. And certainly in high school he was. But you can't take away what Tebow has done in college football.
Dysart's pass overthrown and intercepted. Ahmad Black. Black inside the 10. Black knocked down inside the 5. Some extracurricular activity as well involving running back Thomas Merriweather for Miami. Here's the interception.
It's a good job of Black getting his distance. Bostic causing harassment on Robinson, receiver. And Black trying to take it and house it.
Tip ball caused the interception.
Following the interception, dead ball, personal foul. 34 of the defense. Players ejected. Half the distance to the goal.
Thomas Merriweather throwing a punch, so he's kicked out of the game, and that's Miami's starting running back, frustrated after that interception.
Well, we talked about Miami coming in with a little bit of attitude, but if that attitude becomes detrimental, then I'm Coach Haywood. I'd address that immediately on the sidelines right now to let his team know who's in charge, and that behavior won't be tolerated. Quint?
Well, it was a Florida offensive lineman blocking Merriweather into the end zone, successfully pancaked him. Merriweather, so upset, got off his feet, turned around and punched him, basically, in the back of the head. Referee was right there. He is ejected.
All right, Quint, and Merriweather's backup is a true freshman, Tracy Woods. Danny Green, who's the normal number two running back, violated team rules, so he's suspended for today.
Well, the top two running backs are out, and a true freshman gets the chance.
Here's Gillis Lee, and Miami doing a good job on defense. Nowhere to run. Evan Harris firing in there first for Miami to take down the Florida running back Mike Gillis Lee.
All right, here's a theory that I have. You try to go to run the eye offense, and you're a shotgun spread type of running team. You don't know how to block it. You don't know how to block as an offensive line in a run game. It's just not what you do. You don't work on it all the time. Teams that are good power running football teams line up in the eye, and they fire out the ball. Shotgun, there are more zone blockers. And Miami's beating them to the punch.
The Gators let Merriweather have it as he exits the field. Little pistol formation. Trey Burton, the quarterback. And it's a touchdown. Burton is the backup to John Brantley. And he takes it in from 2 yards out.
Burton is a true freshman who came in to Florida in January, so he got to go through spring practice. And if what you were talking about, Burton is a little Tebow, because that's the play that Tebow would have run if he would have been here, the little quarterback keep.
Both backups to Brantley are true freshmen. Trey Burton, who you saw there, and Tyler Murphy. And it's 21-3 Florida, thanks to another mistake by Miami, Ohio.
You're watching ESPN, new home of the Bowl Championship Series.
At Cheez-It, we expect a lot from our cheese.
What do you call a cheese that isn't yours?
I don't know.
Nacho cheese. See, because it's not your cheese, but I said nacho. La 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 la, can't hear you. La 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 la, can't hear you. La 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 la, can't hear you. That's when I decided to fully invest in my 401k.
We take the time for our cheese to mature before we bake it into every delicious cracker. Because at Cheez-It, real cheese matters.
Chick Hydra, the water-activated gel that hydrates your skin as you shave and lasts up to twice as long as ordinary strips, while five blades with skin guards smooth the skin to reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. The new Chick Hydra. Free your skin.
Reese Davis with you in the studio. There aren't many things that Joe Paterno hasn't done before, but start a freshman quarterback in the opener is one of them until now, and that freshman, Robert Bolden, his first touchdown pass. Brett Brackett caught it, and Penn State has the lead on Youngstown 13-7. Michigan State's gone back on top of Western Michigan, a touchdown pass to the former quarterback, Keith Nichol.
All right, Reese, here it's 21-3 Florida. Trey Burton, true freshman from Venice, Florida, who is the number two quarterback behind John Brantley, and they're running the option out of shotgun on the goal line, gets the touchdown. Here's DeMarco Payne on the return for the Redhawks, trying to get outside and wrestle down at the 24-yard line. Kedrick Johnson on the stop. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series heads back south for Labor Day weekend. Only two races remain for Jamie McMurray and Mark Martin to get off the bubble and into the chase. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series in Atlanta on ESPN tomorrow, 7:30 Eastern. Well, Miami led this game 3-0, but 21 points for Florida in the last 5 minutes and 11 seconds off of turnovers by Miami. Dysart has really struggled since a great first drop. Here's Tracy Woods going nowhere. Bostic on the stop. Woods in there for Thomas Merriweather, who was ejected. And you can see him here on the interception return by Jenkins get pancaked.
He's going to be right here. Now just keep your eye on that player right there and watch the ball. And the player getting driven into the end zone. Bostic is driving him into the end zone. Puts him on his back, which was
that'd
something
get you,
that
get
he
you
took exception. Well, yeah, but, you know, easy solution. Don't get your rim. Put on your back. And you don't have to worry about throwing a sucker punch.
That was the Black interception. The Jenkins interception was returned for a touchdown. So a second and 10 for Miami. Here's an end around, and the Gators not fooled. Loss on the play. Jamal Rogers knew he was dead in the water the second he came around the corner. Yaron Bell, a true freshman, was or ball rather, a true freshman was waiting for him. Minus 8 rushing yards. Florida has minus 17 rushing yards, and they have not been sacked. A lot of times you see negative rushing yards because of sacks in college football, but not today.
One thing that was questioned was all the new guys from Florida's defense, and just from my observation in the first half, they all passed with flying colors.
Not in the first quarter.
Dysart on third and long has an open man. It's a first down. Chris Givens on the catch. Third and 12, and they get about 15.
Now Bostic has been playing a good football game, but the middle linebacker, what he does is jumping underneath route, and he's a young player. So that young player has to understand where the sticks are in coverage. Don't worry about the stuff underneath you. Just don't let them throw over top you. Good job by Dysart seeing Bostic jump the underneath route, and let me lob one over there in the vacated zone.
They fake the end around this time, and Dysart gonna take off and slides to the 38-yard line. Or make that the 42-yard line, excuse me, gave about 3 or 4. Justin Tretto chasing him down.
What's got Miami, Ohio in trouble in this ball game is what gave them fits all last year, and that is turnovers. They led the nation in interceptions with 21 and giveaways with 36. You just can't be a winning football team by giving the ball and helping the other team, especially the Florida Gators.
Dysart on second and 7. Finds Armand Robinson. Trampled at the 47-yard line. Lorenzo Edwards there. And Nate Williams, the right guard for Miami, lost his helmet. We've seen a lot of lost lids.
Yeah.
So far here in the first half.
You know the thing I love, though? I'm sitting here watching this Gator defense, and when you see defensive linemen, four of them making a tackle or jumping on the pile, yeah, 4 or 5 yards down the field, mm-hmm, that's a well-coached football team and a team that's hungry and playing. You know what? But you have that luxury because you have all this depth at Florida. If your Rand ain't running the football, your Rand will be running to the bench.
Five starters back for Florida on defense, but a new defensive coordinator, Terrell Austin, coming over from the NFL, where he was a defensive backs coach in Arizona and Seattle. Oh, excellent balance by Jamal Rogers after making the catch right at the first down marker, put his hand down, and gets to the 45.
Well, Chris, to go back to your point about the defensive line, I think that's the big difference in the Southeastern Conference than, say, the Big Ten and some of the other conferences around, is that the speed, and you talk about speed, well, everybody's got speed in the secondary, but speed in the defensive line. That's why, one of the reasons why the SEC has won the last four BCS championship games is because all that speed, especially in the defensive line.
First down, here's a reverse. Robinson in trouble. Down he goes, lost about 10. Hard to do that against the speed of Florida. Omar Hunter and Lorenzo Edwards there for the Gators.
Yeah, big Omar is running at, I don't know, probably a 4.7 at 300-plus pounds. Take a look at Omar right here. Working inside. Nice adjustment, little burst.
Number six, that's Howard. He's a defensive lineman.
They get after you. They know. I mean, you got four or five other clones right behind them waiting to come in.
Oh, yeah. That's the thing. You look at a guy like number 73, Sharif Floyd, who was in there earlier, a true freshman from Philly. He's a 300-pounder, but he runs like a 200-pounder. They lost a lot. And really the big thing is just the unknown for Florida as that pass is dumped off to DeMarco Payne. Crosses midfield back near the original line of scrimmage. Going to bring up third down and long. But Urban Meyer's got it rolling now here in Gainesville, where guys leave to the NFL, get drafted high, he just plugs other guys in.
He had 25 recruits come in, and probably 15 of the 25 were five-star or four-star recruits. On the depth chart defensively, there are eight true freshmen listed on the depth chart defensively. I mean, where are all those fifth star recruits from last year and the year before? They just keep bringing them in waves.
Yeah, the most guys drafted in the NFL with nine as Dysart's pass is overthrown but flags down. Andrew Cruz, the intended receiver, was bumped by Josh Evans.
Now Josh has got to use his head here. Now he's in great position. Everything is fine. You don't need to do that. You go up and you play the football. And watch here, and I understand what he's trying to do. He's trying to play the man, not take his eyes off the ball, but have some field awareness and where the ball is as a defensive back. And being a four or five-star recruit like Josh is, understand and keep your hands off of the receiver. You don't need that.
He's getting a chance to play today because Will Hill is out, we're told. It is not because of an injury that Hill is not playing
pass
today.
Pass interference, defense 24. Ball will be placed in the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Take a look. He doesn't need to do this, Chris. Look, there's an open. He's coming in, and he has no concept of where the football is. You've got to be able to see ball man. Head on a swivel.
Didn't see the ball.
Third conversion this drive for Miami. This latest one on a penalty.
Now Josh is a young player and a talented player, and he'll get it. He'll learn from that mistake.
And Miami has to use its final timeout. Miami is in Gator territory, but down 21-3 late in the first half.
Go Gators!
Go Gators!
Being a Gator means having a connection. It means finding strength in the strength of others. It's instantly knowing someone you've never met. And it means a change in you that lasts a lifetime. The University of Florida, the foundation for the Gator Nation.
I'm Tim, and this is my Miami experience. You can work one-on-one with a faculty advisor, and you can also direct your own research projects, and you get to publish papers even as a student.
I created Miami's first multicultural publication. My Miami experience has really helped me go way beyond anything I would have experienced at another school, just because I have that academic and that social experience and having to get everything done.
A world of experiences. The Miami experience. Miami University.
Dysart finds Armand Robinson, who breaks a tackle and gets near the 20-yard line. Janoris Jenkins could not bring him down initially. And Miami in business here. They say that he went out of the 25.
I like the offensive game plan that Mike Haywood and his staff has put together. Throwing from the pocket, then they get Dysart outside the pocket on that one. Roll him out, get him away from the rush. Pass completion, move him around.
Here's a pitch to Woods. Cutback lane is there inside the 20 and near the first down marker at the 16. A.J. Jones on the stop. True freshman Tracy Woods from Texas.
Yeah, Tracy got a new jersey on. Number 23 came in with number 24. 24 didn't fit. There's 23 on him.
Have you guys ever heard of that before?
You were trying to find him, huh?
No, I mean, I've been told, but I've never heard. Usually you get that problem solved before the game, like on Wednesday. Game jerseys fit? Yeah, they all fit. Let's go.
Here's Woods again. And he gets drilled. Close to the first down. We'll see where they spot it. Jelani Jenkins with the hit. And a lot of guys having trouble getting their jerseys on in pregame.
Those are, that's offensive linemen. What you usually have to do now is get the Vaseline on the arms and neck and legs and get it all in there. That's tough duty.
They want those jerseys to fit as tight as possible so the defensive linemen don't have any cloth to grab a hold of.
Somebody used too much bleach this week on those white uniforms.
I tell you, if you have a trouble tying your shoes, then you're in problems. Everybody can have a trouble putting a jersey on.
On third and one, Woods appears to have the first down for Miami. Inside a minute to go, Miami is out of timeouts.
So you want to maybe get a little sense of urgency here. Take your time still. The clock does stop on the first down. Get your play, but understand clock management. Again, Zach Dysart, only a sophomore.
So first down and 10 from the 14-yard line of Florida. And it's not like the Gators offense has done a whole lot. They got a total of 14 yards. But because of the Miami mistakes, they're getting points as that pass is behind Givens. Incomplete with coverage by Josh Evans.
That's a miscommunication, Greece.
Exactly. The quarterback thought the receiver was going to break out. They're not on the same page.
Well, they had the slant open. Now, what could happen, as you say, break out? They have the sluggo, which is slant and go. Dysart read slant. Givens read sluggo.
Yeah.
Throw the slant and be at the slant. Where Givens said, well, let me do the slant and go. That's communication.
Dysart. Fade to the end zone, and it's broken up beautifully by Matt Elam. Let's go to Reese in the studio.
All right, guys, coming up on the Bud Light Halftime Report, A.J. Green gets a red light for Georgia. We'll show you how the Dogs are doing without their star wide receiver. Debut for Robert Bolden at Penn State, a true freshman starting the opener at quarterback for Joe Paterno for the very first time. We'll also take you around the country for all of the scores and highlights of the opening Saturday of college football coming up in a matter of seconds. See you in a bit.
All right, Reese, looking forward to getting caught up with you and the gang in the studio.
Take a look now. This is a chance where you got to make a play here. You're in the swamp. You're still in the game. Drop ball.
That Elam is a true freshman, a five-star recruit out of Dwyer High School in South Florida.
Dysart on third and 10, his pass broken up, nearly intercepted, but it hits the ground. Intended for Jamal Rogers, Janoris Jenkins with the pass breakup, fourth down.
You know what, if I'm Florida, I got alert, fake, because we saw two fake punts, and why not? I'm sure if they have two fake punts, they got two fake field goals in there. System, so I'm alert and fake if I'm the Gator defense.
Trevor Cook made a 33-yarder to give Miami a 3-0 lead in the first quarter. This is a 31-yard try. 21-6 Gators with 21 seconds remaining in the half. Well, Miami and Florida have met a lot. Miami, Ohio, and Florida have not. Just one time. Back December 22nd, 1973, the Fighting Ron Zooks in the Tangerine Bowl, which was actually moved to Gainesville for that particular year. And Zook and company beating Florida 16-7. Bill Mallory was the head coach of that team, member of the Cradle of Coaches in Miami, Ohio. And he gave the pregame speech, or the pregame night speech, I should say, last night. And Quint Kesnick has more on that.
I spoke to Coach Mallory before the game. Gave a nice long speech to the Miami team yesterday. Really talked about this game and their whole season. But he referred back to that Tangerine Bowl. He said it was 35 degrees. We brought the cold weather from Ohio. We were undefeated. No one gave us a shot in that game. We had beaten South Carolina and Purdue. And as you mentioned, Ron Zook, Randy Walker, Rob Carpenter, Charlie Varner scored a key touchdown, and their defense got it done. So a huge moment, he said, for Miami football.
Boy, you think of all the great coaches, Ara Parsegian, Bo Schembechler, Woody Hayes, Weeb Eubank, and Paul Brown, great coaches who were players at Miami, Ohio.
Walter Alston was one of the coaches in that, you know, it jumps out at you because you're looking for football, and here Walter Alston is on that list of great coaches.
And some folks traveling from Oxford, Ohio, down to Gainesville. Their team within two scores, 21 seconds left in the half. Trying to keep it away from the deep man, Jeffrey Demps. That's picked up at the 35-yard line. William Green, as you look at some of the members of the Cradle of Coaches, Sid Gilman, coach back in the 40s. Of course, Woody Hayes, a short stint in Miami. Ara Parsegian, John Pont ended up after that stint there taking Indiana to the Rose Bowl in 67. Of course, Bo and Bill Mallory.
Ara lives in South Bend and also in Marco Island, and is obviously a big Notre Dame football fan. And when Urban Meyer was the assistant of staff at Notre Dame, they got to be friends, and they still are. And Ara's message to Urban was, you can win, but just don't beat my Miami University boys too bad.
That's not too bad.
No.
21-6
now,
and really because of Miami mistakes. Florida's offense had a grand total of 12 yards to 102 for Miami. And Urban Meyer is with Quint.
Coach, how would you best describe that first quarter?
Bad ball. Bad ball. It's about as bad as we've played around here, but we'll be all right. We play good defense. We just got to tighten up our offense and make too many damn mistakes.
Yeah, 14 net yards. What needs to change on offense?
14 net yards. I'd say everything.
Thanks,
14
Coach.
Net yards.
All right, Quinn. Urban seems a little calmer, though, than maybe in years past in those situations. 21-6, his team leads Miami as we stand here to Reese, Mark, and Lou in the Bud Light Halftime Report.
Sporting Goods Kickoff Week.
Year 1 AT after Tebow in Florida in its first game with John Brantley as the starting quarterback leading Miami, Ohio 21-6. With Bob Greasy, Chris Spielman, I'm Dave Paschal. Urban Meyer, guy says that even after his health scare, he's just as intense as he was before, which means if you're a Gator player, he just got lit up in that locker room.
Quint told him 14 yards total offense, and he repeated that as he was going into the locker room. So he probably spoke to the offense a little bit and told them, hey, we're not playing the way we should. The offensive line is the one that really it all starts with. They're not playing very well in this ballgame either.
Yeah, and I credit the Red Hawk defense for playing fast and furious. And if you're Urban Meyer, the one thing you say is hold on to the football. I mean, that's cliche, I know, but it's true. And also that, hey, Gator offense, you got an obligation and responsibility to live up to. Start living up to it because you're not doing it so far.
Now, John Brantley in that first half, 9 of 11 passing for 31 yards and a touchdown. He did have a deep pass that was right on the money, but a good play by Miami, Ohio defensive back to break it up in the end zone.
Yeah, DJ Brown playing the hands as opposed to the ball.
And we'll see Brantley early here. As Miami, Ohio kicking off a pooch kick. They want no part of Jeff Dent, but they're going to get him here. And the speedster, maybe the fastest player in college football out near the 40. Here's Quinn Kesnick.
Dave, I spoke with Mike Haywood, head coach of Miami. He told me a couple of things. Really happy with the way his defense is playing. Offensively, though, he says when we fall behind schedule, we get ourselves into trouble. We've got to make non-emotional decisions. He compared it to being a CEO. He says we just got to be focused, rational, and smart. I also asked him about the decisions in the kicking game. The first fake was a call from the sideline. The second wasn't. The second was a read by the young punter.
So it was Ryan Kennedy then who made the decision to throw down the sideline. It was incomplete, and Florida took over on the 21 and took it in and scored. Here's Emmanuel Moody. And a good stick by Jarrell Wedge. Gain of a handful as we look at the first half stats. Look at that. 13 yards for Florida. 106 interception return yards, including 67 on a touchdown.
They had three interceptions for 106 yards. And look down here at the bottom. Average drive start for my Florida is on the Miami 45-yard line.
Seemed like it was a little better than that, didn't it? Based on the Miami turnovers, they give him seven on the carry by Moody. There's a little misdirection, and Dents has the first down. Takes it to the 46-yard line of Miami territory, where Jordan Gafford makes the stop.
Well, Florida's gone big, and they put big number 77 in there. Ian Silberman, a young offensive tackle, is coming off the field now, but doubles as a slash tight end smash blocker. And it looks like to me Urban's sending a message, let's go back to Olivia Newton-John and let's get physical. Because they weren't physical in the first half.
Well, Urban told us yesterday he wants his running backs to have a special year. Now, it's been Tim Tebow that's been the leading rusher, had close to 1,000 yards last season. But Brantley, a passer, looking to show off the arm here, but he overthrows his intended receiver, Carl Moore. E.J. Brown again on the coverage.
I'm sure that when John Brantley looks at this tape tomorrow, he's going to see, hey, I didn't have to throw that ball so quickly. I had plenty of time. I could have let the receiver run because I got all kinds of time. He just threw it too soon. He would have waited, then he probably could have completed.
And also had Chris Rainey sneaking in the flat, and the corner was playing way off. Rainey would have had some room to work. That's a progression. Even though he's a fourth-year guy, it's still a learning experience.
Here's Brantley hitting Rainey, who doesn't get much, brought down by Jordan Brown after a gain of a couple. Rainey was a running back last year and was moved to receiver this year. 13 career catches and 174 career rushes coming into this season. I think he can be a big-time guy in the slot for him.
He may be a big-time guy, but he's a small man. He's 5'9 and 178. But he's got some quicks.
You got to make people miss out in open space, so you're there to make people miss. Use those quicks.
Miami coming up the middle, and Kennedy chasing Brantley, and Brantley tripped up and dives to the 40. He'll come up about 4 yards short of a first down. Gafford there on the stop. And it's fourth and about four.
Yeah, first of all, I go for this. Send a message to my team that I believe in you. Athleticism right here by Brantley. Talking about not as good an athlete as Tebow. The coaches think he's a pretty good athlete. Right there showing great effort and strength to put them in a position to make a choice on whether to go for it on fourth down or punt.
They're going to go on fourth and five. John Brantley the fourth, John the third. His father was a quarterback in Florida in the late 70s. Scott also played here as a linebacker.
See if they got the shotgun snap worked out. Low again.
Yep, Pouncey had trouble with that in the first half. Not going to get it here. Great hit by D.J. Brown. He's had a whale of a game. The catch was made by Rainey, but he gets stopped 2 yards short of the first down.
It's fourth down. You want to. The quarterback wants to get the pass off, and you have to reach down and worry about the snap. This just is unacceptable. Good play by the cornerback, Brown. Coming up and seeing the play and making the tackle.
Now we talked about this again. We talked about this the first half. We pointed out before the snap, the ball is low, and Brantley loses sight and does not see D.J. Brown coming up from a cover two position to put the knockout on Rainey.
The pitch to Tracy Woods, and nothing doing on first and 10. Well, remember the first snap by Mike Pouncey in the first quarter was not only low, but it was outside. It got away from Brantley, and they lost about 30 yards, and the fumble was recovered by Miami.
Well, we talk about corrections that need to be made, and when you watch the film, I promise you the number one priority going into that coaches meeting is between the offensive line coach and the quarterback coach, that we have to get this down because this is unacceptable. It's killing us.
It's just another thing for the quarterback to worry about before he does all of his other stuff.
Dysert gets out of the pocket and scrambles to about the 41.
Number four, Zach Dysert carries.
Dysert is a good-looking quarterback. He's a big guy, 6'4", 215. He's a redshirt sophomore, played all the games, most of the games last year, and he is the leading returning quarterback in the Mid-American Conference this year. I like this kid. He was the leading rusher on this team last year, if you don't take away all the sack yardage. I mean, he can run.
Dysert on third and long pass deflected, almost intercepted by Ahmad Black. It was broken up by Janoris Jenkins. Both Jenkins and Black have interceptions already today.
Well, Janoris is stout top of that corner. He is a solid football player. We'll see his shot right here that Zach Dysert's going to take from right up the middle.
Justin Trattow that hit him.
Nice little game they ran. They tried to get speed on that defensive front. So they move Trattow into a two technique. That's an inside defensive tackle.
Thank you.
There you go.
I'm looking. Two, what's two? Three, two.
Zach Murphy to punt. Hey, a real punt.
And a good one.
Only the second one of the day. Fair caught by Rainey at the 22. Now, Florida lost a lot on defense, but they got some good players coming back like Justin Trapp.
I picture myself on a great cliff with the Guardians.
On September 24th.
Your head
is filled with dreams.
There's nothing wrong with dreams.
If you believe in the legend.
You're gonna find the Guardians of Gahul.
You will become.
Get them!
Look out!
A hero.
Make strong the weak and vanquish evil.
You too can be a great Guardian.
Follow me!
Legend of the Guardians.
At least you'll have the helmet for it.
In theaters and IMAX 3D. Rated PG.
I'm a Wrangler guy. Always have been, always will be.
Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans. For long-lasting comfort, the right choice is Wrangler.
Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
If you want to get ripped like Jeremy Shockey ripped, then you need to get Tubes. They unlock secret muscles you never even knew you had. Think about that.
Secret muscles.
They lead across frozen rivers, from island to island, to build hope and carry on the ideals of a nation. Officers in the U.S. Army can rise to any challenge. They bring out the best in others and themselves. Can you? Start leading at goarmy.com/officer. There's strong, and then there's Army Strong.
You are faithful. You wear your colors with pride. This is your place. SECstore.com. All the gear, all the goods, all the colors you need for suiting up each week. A one-stop shop for SEC fans with all the conference merchandise right at your fingertips. At championship time, it's the quickest way to get officially licensed championship caps and tees. Great quality, huge variety, quick shopping, easy clicking, fast shipping. Every day, anytime at SECstore.com.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio. Welcome back to College Football on ESPN, presented by Cars.com.
Florida's won 20 straight season openers, and the last three by an average of 50 points, but they're having all kinds of trouble hanging on to the football today against Miami. Hard to tell if that was the snap or on the quarterback Brantley as he gets wrapped up. He and Pouncey have not been on the same page on those shotgun snaps.
That's easy. That's on the quarterback. He took his eye off the ball. Take a look right here. That ball was nice and tight right to his chest.
Yep.
Little nerves, first start. You know, he's been around for 4 years. He's a redshirt junior, so he's been here. He knows the system. It's just the first time that Tebow has not been around, and it's all on you.
And another bad snap. Brantley in trouble back near the goal line. They rule him down inside the one. That one was on Pouncey. Remember, he's replacing his brother Marquise, who left Florida for the NFL. Mike was a guard last year, but Urban moving him to center this year.
Now, I can't emphasize enough, if this is 75% of your offense, you better find a new offense if it's going to be like this all year.
You can see Pouncey, he rises before he completes the snap. You got to complete the snap. You know, and if he can't do it, then just move him back to right guard and put Roby, the backup center, in. Now they're both lack of confidence in this situation.
And you do that here, and you're going to give up at least 2 points. That's a good snap. Brantley near the back of the end zone, throws right at the goal line. They're going to rule that it's caught and out of the end zone. Demps was hit immediately by Luke Kelly. It's based on where the ball was when forward progress was stopped, and they feel that he just got out of the end zone.
Ooh. This is kind of a risky play to be caught back in your end zone. You're just throwing.
On the catch, the ball was past the goal line.
Giving him the benefit of the doubt, just barely over the line.
The goal line, now the plane is the front part of the goal line. It's under review right now, so people understand it's the front part of the goal line, not the back part of the goal line.
But it looked like there, just right where he caught it, that it was out by a little bit. And again, it's got to be indisputable video evidence to overturn the ruling of the field.
Going with offense again, Dave, huh? Going to the dark side? Obviously, you can't see that. Can we see it again?
Let's see it one more time. Going to break.
I think it was behind, but what do I know?
Our first official review of the day. This was actually a good snap. They finally get a good snap. Hard to tell from that angle whether it's a safety or fourth down.
Let me show you how to be a top cornerback. Use those Nike Zoom Vapor Carbon Fly cleats to cover your man like shade. And use those Nike Vapor Jet gloves to bury your man in coverage.
Now that you got that receiver on your island, you can keep him there for the whole game. But make sure you name your island. They call mine Revis. What's your last name?
Gilligan.
The Nike Vapor Carbon Cleat and Vapor Jet Glove at Dick's Sporting Goods. Better athlete, better team. With deposits in your engine, it can feel like something's holding your car back.
Let me guess, 16.
That's why there's Castrol GTX, with superior protection against harmful deposit buildup. Don't let deposits hold your car back. Get Castrol GTX. It's more than just oil. It's liquid engineering.
You hear about the new Intel Core processors?
Oh, yeah. They're faster. They're smarter. Genius.
Such a breakthrough. Makes you wonder what else is going on around here.
Yeah, who knows?
Hey, Walter.
Meet the 2010 Intel Core processor family.
At Pizza Hut, everyone loved our $10 any pizza deal, so we've made even bigger changes. We've lowered the price of every pizza on our menu. Now, a large pizza with up to three of your favorite toppings is just $10, or any medium specialty pizza is just $10 too, only at your Pizza Hut.
For 10 years, StubHub has been the place to find great tickets to sports, concerts, and more, even on the day of the event, and even if it's sold out. But if you didn't use StubHub, we suggest you pack accordingly. StubHub, where do you want to sit?
Back in Gainesville, the ruling on the field stands. They did not have indisputable video evidence, although they had a pretty good shot of it. Our crew did a great job right along the end zone. Looks like the ball on the catch by Demps is out.
Yeah, 2 points. I think the correct spot, and Brantley has to throw the ball at his feet. You got to take that away because there's too many defenders around the receiver.
Christopher Guido is the long snapper. It was a good snap, but a horrible punt takes a Miami bounce inside the 30. Guido, the long snapper, downs it around the 28. There's an injured Gator. It's a guy who started today, Moses Jenkins, at corner because Jeremy Brown has been battling an ankle injury. This game not over yet. And Miami's going to have good field position inside the Florida 30. I mean, right now the Gators can barely snap the ball.
Well,
we'll come back to Gainesville in a moment. Going to take a timeout. 21-6 Florida.
Game two of the Western Conference Finals, Seattle versus Phoenix, Sunday at 3 on ABC.
He is the life of parties he has never attended. If he were to punch you in the face, you would have to fight off the strong urge to thank him. Sharks have a week dedicated to him. He is the most interesting man in the world.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer those Zackies. Stay thirsty, my friends.
Where do you want to sit this college football season? How about the best seats in the stadium courtesy of StubHub? Enter ESPN and StubHub's Ultimate College Football Fan Sweepstakes for a chance to win a college football experience of a lifetime. Log on to ESPN.com, search StubHub, and submit a story, picture, or video showing us why you're the ultimate fan. You'll be judged on your originality, loyalty, and passion for your favorite team. So where do you want to sit? Enter to win ESPN and StubHub's Ultimate College Football Fan Sweepstakes, and you could be sitting pretty.
Every 60 seconds, someone, somewhere, is making the switch to Tempur-Pedic. Now, it's your turn. Call now for your free information kit, including a Tempur material sample, along with a DVD and catalog. Traditional mattresses use metal springs that can cause pressure points, causing you to toss and turn. Only the Tempur-Pedic mattress automatically adjusts to your body while keeping your spine in perfect alignment. Plus, because Tempur-Pedic doesn't transfer motion, you won't disturb your partner when you get out of bed or shift positions. Best of all, Tempur-Pedic will let you sleep on one of their sleep systems for an incredible 90 nights before you make your purchase decision. If you want the ultimate in comfort, if you wish to get more sleep but can't, it's time you make the switch to Tempur-Pedic.
Call 1-800-346-2174 for your free information kit. That's 1-800-346-2174. Call today.
ESPN's College Football, brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. And Castrol GTX, with superior protection against harmful deposit buildup.
Back in Gainesville, where Dicer throws an incompletion on first and 10, trying to hit Nick Harwell. But the first game of the post-Tim Tebow era of Florida football not going so well, and they've lost another defensive back. Moses Jenkins are looking at his left arm. And he was filling in for Jeremy Brown, the normal starter at corner.
There's Moses.
Jeremy Brown battling an ankle injury. Jenkins trying to brace his fall there.
Yeah, it looks like he jammed his forearm into the turf.
Now Miami's run a little bit better since Tracy Woods came in the game for Thomas Merriweather, who got kicked out. They don't need to run the ball though right now. Good throw by Dicer, hitting Robinson down to the 12-yard line.
It's a nice route, nice pitch and little catch. Man coverage in the secondary. Robinson just goes down, comes in and out. Big first down for Miami.
That's the old option route. Dicer reads the defensive back. If he's on the outside, he throws it inside. If the defensive back is inside, he throws it outside. And Jeremy Brown, who hurt his ankle a little bit on Thursday afternoon, getting some action, coming back from two back surgeries the previous 2 years.
He did not start, but he's out there now. No choice. First down at the 12-yard line. Inside handoff, and they're not full. Florida has not fallen for any of those trick plays offensively. A.J. Jones in there knocking down Armand Robinson for a loss.
It took forever to develop. I mean, I'm still waiting for him to hand the ball off.
Jones just makes a great play. Comes in from the outside linebacker spot. Defensive line, defensive secondary for Florida playing really well. It's just the offense that's surprising here for the Gators.
44 yards. Total offense for Florida.
Don't mess with the bull. The bull's got him dialed in today.
Dysart on second down, pumps, and he's loose inside the 15. Tripped up by Tretto. Gain of about six. College football season in mid-season form with a BCS buster in week one. Andy Dalton, TCU against Jacquizz Rodgers and Oregon State tonight, 7:45. It's college football primetime, presented by Hampton Hotels, part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week. TCU guys, a national title contender in your opinion?
No. In my opinion, no. But could they be? Yeah, because their schedule isn't as difficult as a lot of teams like Florida or Alabama.
If they win the non-conference games early in the week in their schedule, they're going to run the rest of them.
Dysart on third down and 11. Moving around, throwing end zone, and overthrows Cruz. Coverage downfield by Florida, pretty good in the end zone. Janoris Jenkins was there. Meanwhile, Moses Jenkins, injured on special teams, might be done for the day. And Trevor Cook is 2 for 2 today. He was only 7 of 12 last year, but the Miami coaches say he's been the surprise of training camp, doing his job so far. 31-yard try.
Down the middle.
21-9. Florida on top. Mike Haywood's Red Hawks not done yet. Down 12 midway through the third.
Are things different now that I'm not crushing quarterbacks every Sunday?
Yeah, a little bit. But I still have a taste for greatness.
So I love Dr. Pepper. The taste of these 23 flavors can never be equaled. Like me.
Pizza for McNabb.
I got it.
Donovan.
Mike? Who is Mike?
Come on, Mike, man.
Still got it.
There's nothing like a pepper. Trust me. I've sent people to the doctor.
Now it's time for our AT&T All-America Player of the Week update. Certainly a leading candidate from the opening night of college football. Matt Barkley of USC threw for 257 yards and 5 touchdowns, and the Trojans needed most of them as the defense gave up 36, the 49-36 victory for SC. You can text the word VOTE to 345-345 from your mobile phone. Cast your vote for the Player of the Week and get a chance to win a trip to the national championship game.
In that game, Lane Kiffin was faking extra points. Here we've got several fake punt attempts. One very costly for Miami, Ohio. Who knows what the score would be right now if not for a fake punt that failed inside Miami's 25. Urban Meyer told Quinn Kestnick at halftime he's very disappointed. Can't remember a half that went that poorly for his football team. Not getting a whole lot better here in the second half.
I don't think Urban's having much fun today.
And again, try to keep it away from Demps. Taken by Gillislee. Across the 40, breaks a tackle. And knocked out of bounds near the Miami 30-yard line.
This is what Florida has. They've got so many players that are explosive. Gillislee, they've got Rainey and Demps. Down the sideline, special teams for Florida are a big, big part of this team.
They made an adjustment on a short kickoff, too. Normally, Miami's kicker would read the short man. Gillislee started in the middle, read the kicker's kick, and went over and fielded the ball, as opposed to kicking it opposite of Gillislee, which they did the first few kickoffs that they've had.
Yeah, they've been kicking it short all day.
17 total yards for Florida's offense, in part because of bad snaps. And running play, not much there for Moody. Our Bud Light playbook, we talked about the fake punt. Here was actually a punt by Ryan Kennedy, run about 12 yards. And the fake that worked. Kennedy with a pass that somehow Kendrick Bruton caught. And then the other one, we're told that Kennedy had the choice, and he elected to take the snap and try to complete a pass down the sideline on fourth down. That led to a Florida touchdown. It's 21-9 Gators. They'll run it on second down. The up man, Trey Burton, who had a touchdown in the first half, gets a couple.
Trey Burton slash quarterback slash tight end slash H-back slash fullback. In other words, pure athlete.
Slash true freshman. This kid just came in January, so, you know, he hasn't been around the program that long.
They see him playing in that Tebow role as the Wildcat quarterback and also as a tight end. And as you said, fullback, Chris. Third and four. Brantley with time. His pass incomplete. Intended for Chris Rainey. Now Florida's gone for it several times on fourth down so far in this game. We'll see what they do here in fourth and four.
I saw the signal caller in the orange shirt down there giving a big double wave. Stay on the field. He looked at Urban. Urban looked at the orange shirt. The orange shirt said, go for it. All fourth downs, Miami has come with blitzes. Carl Bull Reese dialing them up.
Florida 0 for 2 so far. Brantley in trouble and somehow zips it in there to Deontay Thompson for the first down at the 19.
And the Gator crowd cheering for a successful snap and a successful first down completion.
Here's the message Urban is sending. We're running I-backs, so we're going to shove it down your throat, Miami. Let's see if you can answer the challenge.
Here's Moody on first down. It's a couple brought down by Kennedy. Let's check in with Quint.
Dave, center Mike Pouncey came off to the sideline after that last series, ripped his helmet off, sat down with his head down, shaking his head in disbelief, really unhappy with himself. He got a pat on the back from a fellow center, Sam Roby. Steve Adazio took a knee in front of him, actually didn't even talk to him about his snaps. I did ask a ball boy, are they using a new football? Because sometimes the new football is going to be slippery. He said, no, they've been buffed, they've been sandpapered. Clearly, it's not the football, it's the human.
Every snap has been adventurous. And again, trouble. This time Brantley got the snap, and he and Moody collided. He was trying to give the inside handoff or fake it, and he lost the ball.
Well, the timing isn't there. He doesn't get the snap in time. It's a bad snap. Moody is there too quickly. You know, it's just timing. You know, the strength of this offense coming back was supposed to be the offensive line. They were supposed to have four guys up there that were really solid, all conference-type guys. Had to replace some of the skill position, but you know, this is just all timing.
This is ridiculous, isn't it, guys, to see this many bad snaps by a school like Florida?
That's off target, and it's also a screwball coming back there.
Flag down on third and 13.
It's not a Bob Greasy type pass, that tight spiral. It's a screwball coming back there, which makes it even more difficult to handle, especially if it's outside or low and away.
Prior to the snap, false start, 76 offense, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Brantley wants the fastball, and all he's getting is curves and knucklers.
Well, in the spring game, I saw some of the spring game on television, and a lot of the snaps in that game, I remember, were high. So the problem then, where they were all, everybody, everything was high.
And guys, people that may not be watching this game but see the highlights later and see the final score, whatever it is, this for John Brantley is just going to add to the pressure of trying to replace Tim Tebow, because that's what people are going to be talking about. Third down and long. Brantley going end zone, and it is incomplete. Intended for Carl Moore. I think they're going to try the field goal here. It's fourth and 18.
Well, you think. Yeah, there they come. Well, Carl Moore gets away with a push. Watch this. That's a nice little job of pushing off delicately, but ran out of real estate. Demetrius Quarles, true freshman, outstanding position.
These defensive guys are always looking for that. It's like he's got a flag in his pocket.
Well, you didn't see the push?
I saw it.
Okay.
Throw was out of bounds.
I saw it.
Wouldn't have caught it anyway. 44-yard field goal attempt by Caleb Sturgis. And it's way off. It remains 21-9.
You know something, boys? This is interesting. I'm just watching Urban on the sidelines. And this is a test. Seriously, he's going to take this game. If it stays close and it stays competitive and they keep playing bad, it's going to be like a loss. Now, is he going to be able to sleep after? Because we saw in with Tom Rinaldi in ESPN's game day that he couldn't sleep after a loss. It's the same way. This is almost worse because you're looking forward to what am I going to do next? Also, it will get him more focused, more determined to get these boys back in shape and get going. But this is something where he might question, am I making the right decisions on how I'm approaching my football team?
Little shovel pass to Robinson, plows forward across the 35 and near the first down marker at the 37-yard line. Jonathan Bostic on the stop for Florida.
Does that make sense to you guys? I mean, he's going to question himself because that's the first thing he looks at. He doesn't look at the center, the snapper, the quarterback, DB. He looks in the mirror and says, Urban, what are you doing?
It's just a good thing that they're not playing an SEC opponent today. Tennessee on the road that's coming up in a couple of weeks, or some of the other teams, because this is not winning football.
There's Meyer talking with his quarterback, John Brantley, about what's gone wrong. On first down, Robinson again with a catch. Good throw by Dicer. Gain of about 8. Well, to your point, Chris, remember Urban Meyer is making an effort to exercise more and eat better. Normally, he would meet with the TV crew at noon. He did it with us yesterday about 11 so he could get his normal workout in at noon. You start to wonder, as you said, does he question, boy, should I work out today? I need to study film more. I need to work with my coaches a little bit more and maybe skip a meal, something that hurt his health in previous years.
I don't think he needs to do that, but he's going to ask himself that. You know why? I would ask myself that.
And a late hit as play was stopped. Lawrence Marsh hit Dysart and going to get flagged. There was already a marker down and a dead ball foul.
And the whistles were blowing before Marsh hit the quarterback.
And I'm not just making that assumption. I've known the guy for 20-some years, so I understand how his brain thinks a little bit.
He was a grad assistant when you were a player at Ohio State.
With two fouls on the play, false start, number 13 of the offense. Dead ball, personal foul, 90 of the defense. Both penalties will be enforced. It'll end up first and 10.
Remember last year after the SEC championship game, Urban Meyer rushed to the hospital with the chest pains, was treated for dehydration, did not know what it was, thought it might be a heart problem, so he resigns December 26th. And then the next day, decided instead to take a leave of absence. Says he was worried about his staff losing their job, so he felt loyalty to them. Found out in January that it was esophageal spasms, and then came back full-time officially mid-March. Here's a rollout on a pass by Dysart that's caught near the first down marker. Nick Hartwell will get some breaking news meanwhile with Reese Davis.
All right, Dave, a glorious college career has not gotten off to a very good start in the NFL career for Matt Leinart, and the Arizona Cardinals have decided to cut ties with Matt Leinart, the former USC star, according to reports. Arizona plans to release the former Trojan sometime today.
All right, Reese, more on that in a second. I just want to touch on that real quick. First down for Miami at the 34-yard line. Dysart with a flag down, dumps it off, and tackled immediately as Rogers. And another penalty flag thrown in the backfield as Dysart was hit late again.
There's also one on the 35-yard line.
Yep. As they sort this out, guys, just a quick comment on Leinart, because I know you guys watch him in college, and I've done every pro game of Leinart's. He's regressed. And I just think he completely lost his confidence.
Well,
and that's a reason why he's not the quarterback.
I think he was as good as he was ever going to be in college. The softball that he threw, he didn't, you know, he could get by with that in college. But in the pros, I mean, he was a smart kid. And he was great for college football. But I just, You have to have a strong arm to play in the NFL.
You better want it. I mean, I don't know the guy. I don't know if he works his rear end off season. I don't know if he's a strong presence in the locker room. If he doesn't, then obviously he doesn't have the intangibles to be an NFL quarterback.
We have two fouls on the play. Offsides, number one, that penalty's declined. Personal foul, roughing the passer, number one.
Another late hit on the quarterback costs Florida.
That's Janoris Jenkins coming on a corner blitz. He has two fouls. And the second one was the one hitting the quarterback up near the head.
Miami in the red zone. Dicer to Robinson. Great catch out in space. Stumbles forward for a gain of about two with Ahmad Black tackling.
Here comes Jenkins. You can't do that. His helmet went directly to Dicer. That referee is doing nothing but looking at that quarterback.
That's a good call, but it's a sad call because he's seeing and hitting with his eyes. He's seeing what he's hitting. He's hitting what he's seeing. I mean, he's not going to go. What are you going to do? Go low and take his knees out there, I guess.
I agree. You're a defensive guy. I agree with that. Yeah. It's tough on these. But you safety first.
They fake the draw. Dysart unloading, and it's caught by Robinson at the 5-yard line.
You know what? Zach Dysart, three interceptions in the first half. He's come, what a veteran now. I mean, here's a guy that you talk about composure and not getting rattled, and just started to let him play football. He's like he's not in a swamp. He's like he's back in Ada, Ohio, throwing a rocket around at Ada Park.
Started 9 games last year, 62% completion percentage. 12 touchdowns and 16 interceptions.
Remember, guys, this Miami team won one game last year. Florida lost one game.
Miami's sprinting down the end of the field over their sideline. Florida's walking. Interesting.
We go to the fourth. Miami inside the 10, down only 12 to number 4, Florida.
New fall show, No Ordinary Family. Get a peek at ABC.com.
There's no way to hide it. If you drive drunk, we will find you. Cops everywhere are stepping up enforcement and cracking down like never before.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Sir, have you been drinking this evening?
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Make no mistake. You will get caught, and you will be arrested. Over the limit, under arrest.
Welcome to Progressive. Nice calculator.
I'm just trying to save money on my car insurance.
You know, with Progressive, you get the option to name your price.
Is that even possible?
Absolutely. Trade?
And I still get great service?
More like super great. Oh, you have a message. Hello.
Calculator humor.
I'll be here all week. I will. That was my schedule.
The freedom to name your price. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
Closed captioning for selected programming is brought to you by ShapeUps.
Introducing ShapeUps SRT, Skechers Radius Trainer for men. Get more out of your workout with ShapeUps SRT by Skechers.
There once was a hungry road that wouldn't let drivers get very far. It wore out their tires, forcing them to buy new ones time and time again. Then along came the Michelin man who proved the right tire changes everything. And with long-lasting tires in place, those drivers were back on the road to saving money. Michelin Hydro-Edge tires last up to 33,000 miles longer. Michelin, a better way forward.
Wow, that guy's really staring over here. Must have sold him some carpeting or something.
Mike, check out his bacon neck.
Bacon?
Sir, lean forward and show Michael Jordan your collar. Oh. See how it's all curled up like bacon in a pan? See how bad this dude looks?
What's that?
Thank you.
Okay.
Not us, though, buddy. I lay flats. We're like twins.
No, we're not.
Yeah, we are.
No, we're not.
Yeah.
Lay flat collar. Lays flat, won't bacon.
only from Haynes.
I don't see anything yet.
Now, over there, we just got to keep going left.
What's your deal with going left?
Join the fun at our U.S. Army Celebration event this weekend at Bass Pro Shops.
Miami, Ohio coaches and players hoping for the upset of a lifetime. They trail by 12, but they are at the Florida 5. Dicer taking off and gets popped at the 3-yard line by Matt Elam. It'll bring up second and goal. What to you guys is more astonishing? The fact that Florida has just 26 yards of total offense, or the fact that Zach Dicer has done a pretty good job against their defense?
Well, yeah, you take away the pick six that Florida has. You know, we're talking about Miami going in with the score here. Now, Coach Haywood said this: the team must overcome a negative psychological disposition that permeated through the program. I'll tell you what that means in a minute, Dave.
Okay, thank you. Please interpret.
In other words, this team thought they weren't very good, no self-confidence. This is one way to build it. It's one thing to talk about it, but when you're able to bring it to the field, that shows him, it shows his players, mission accomplished so far.
Miami, the first time out of the half.
So Haywood calls timeout, and he had to do that a few times in the first half when it looked like they were not going to be able to get the playoff. And you think about it, you know, Miami, throughout its history, has had a lot of success in the MAC, going back to Ben Roethlisberger's days as the quarterback there. Fallen on hard times of late, just one win a year ago. But pretty amazing what they're doing down here in Gainesville.
You know, one of the things that I'm surprised about is everybody was talking about a 12 noon start, hot in Florida. It's Florida with all this depth and all these players, and Miami coming down here. Miami was the team that was running from one end to the other end at the start of the fourth quarter. It wasn't the Gators that were getting tired. That Miami was getting tired. It looked like the Gators were kind of disheveled and down a little bit.
And the Gators are getting their rear ends kicked. Even though the scoreboard doesn't say it, on the field tells me they're getting their rear ends kicked. And they got to respond to the challenge. They're a young team. Let's see what you have. It's on the goal line.
Miami's been more physical.
Let's show.
No question. Dicer to throw, going end zone, flags are down, and it's incomplete. Intended for Andrew Cruz, Matt Elam had coverage. Let's see who the penalties are.
A lot of flags, huh? Should be surprised in the first game of the year.
Illegal shift on the offense. Two men moving, failure to get set. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
You think of all the mental errors by Miami, the penalties and the turnovers, yet they're still in this football game.
Oh, he had two guys moving. The one guy wasn't set before the other guy started in motion.
It's on the quarterback to make sure they're set, right, Bruce?
Well, not when they're 30 yards away from them. You can't control that.
Dicer on second and goal. His pass is broken up. Incomplete. It'll bring up third down and goal. A.J. Jones, senior linebacker from Tampa.
He went all high hurdler on everybody. This is a great athletic play. Watch A.J. coming in from the top of your screen, number 16 coming in. Get up, that's it. Jump and get that vertical. Outstanding.
Well, guys, what do you call here? It's third down and goal from the 8. Are you thinking it's 4-down territory if you're Miami? Or are you hoping, if nothing else, you get the 3?
I think you get the 3. You still have time, and you're getting the field position.
Yeah, but are you ever going to be in this good a field position? I mean, it all went to Coach Brown. You want to walk out here feeling good about yourself, or you want to try and win?
And they do throw underneath, and it's caught. Robinson breaking tackles, muscling his way toward the goal line. They're going to spot him down at the 1, and it looks like Miami's going to go, but now a flag comes in. A late penalty flag came in on the goal line.
Now you go for it. On 4th and 1 as opposed to 4th and 9.
Unless there's a penalty on Miami for a dead ball foul here.
Great job by Robinson, fighting and clawing. Yes. Doing everything, carrying Gators and trying to get into the end zone.
6'1", 200 pounds.
Reynoldsburg, Ohio. Right outside of Columbus, I might add.
Robinson had 67 catches a year ago. Third team all MAC.
Following the play, dead ball. Personal foul
11 of the offense. Wow. Unnecessary roughness. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. Fourth down.
Just not smart. You got fourth down and goal at the one, and now you're back at the 16 because of Robinson's personal foul. Robinson there with the football, and there you see the kick.
You make a nice play. You make a good, tough play. The defense is allowed to tackle you, two, three, four guys, and then they, you know how they do, they lay on you, and they grabbing at you. You can't do something dumb like that.
I mean, was it that big of a kick?
Well, you can't kick. Kick, especially while you're on the ground up in the air. They're going to call that. Merriweather, remember, got kicked out for a punch earlier in the game. They're starting running back. 33-yard field goal attempt. And Trevor Cook is money again, 4 for 4. But it remains a two-possession game, 21-12. Florida on top.
Sandwich lady, 2 o'clock.
Oh.
Hey.
5:50.
Actually, we're all good today, sandwich lady. We love your chicken sandwiches, but Taco Bell's got chicken flatbread sandwiches for under $1, so.
5:50.
No. 550. Under a buck. You don't scare me.
It's under a buck, and not everyone's happy about it. The new chicken flatbread sandwich. Warm flatbread, flame grilled chicken, and melty cheese. Only at Taco Bell. Why pay more?
The longer you keep your high-mileage car, the more it pays you back. Get Castrol GTX High Mileage. It helps engines last longer by fighting the main causes of engine failure. Don't change your car. Change your oil to Castrol GTX High Mileage. It's more than just oil. It's liquid engineering.
Battling the elements for over 130 years, our wood stains can handle just about anything. Cabot, our performance is legendary.
Gordon Gekka was the biggest name on Wall Street before he went to prison.
Mr. Gekka, my name is Jacob Moore. I'm going to marry your daughter.
I think you're going to be part of the family business. It's easy to get in. It's hard to get out.
When you don't know what you're doing, it's fatal.
He'll hurt us.
Just like the old days, we slaughtered men for payback.
Wall Street, money never sleeps. Rated PG-13, September 24th.
Man, you guys are always competing.
We're not competing.
Jenga, Texas style, baby.
Wow, I thought my second national championship ring was going to get in the way on that one.
Hey, guys. Back in the day,
I used to be a Jenga master.
Hungry hippos, baby. It's on.
ESPN College Game Day, built by the Home Depot. Saturdays at 9 a.m. on ESPNU. Continues at 10 a.m. on ESPN.
Reese Davis with you in the studio. Get you up to date on other games on the family of networks. Michigan State up comfortably on Western Michigan. The game is going on ESPN2. The Jimbo Fisher era is off to a rousing start. 56-6 over Samford on ESPNU, and Jimbo's taking his foot off the gas. But the story of the day unfolding in the swamp right now, Dave.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people thought, Reese, that 56-6 score Florida State over Samford would be similar to what we'd see here in Gainesville. Instead, it's 21-12, and Florida with the lead has been held to 25 yards total offense. First game of the post Tim Tebow era. But it's not all John Brantley's fault. There have been bad snaps, turnovers, mental errors as well. Seth Phillip to kick off. They have been kicking away from the return man, Jeff Dem. So this time he kicks it deep. Dems crosses the 20 and out to the 25. Good coverage. Take a look at our protection spotlight brought to you by Castrol GTX. Florida unable to protect the football. That was in the first quarter. It was recovered by Miami, and they led 3-0. Mike Conte really struggling. Brantley's also drops up. By our count, we have 12 questionable snaps by Florida today.
On those last two bad snaps, they're asking Pouncey to snap the ball and pull. They're asking him to snap the ball and pull around the end. Now,
Miguel Carradine, shaken up redshirt senior from here in Gainesville for Florida. We get a timeout, 21-12, Florida on top.
From an early age, Timothy Richmond understood that with knowledge comes confidence. In junior high, while abroad, he explained how jellyfish stings can be neutralized with vinegar.
Aceto Olivia Dolore.
In perfect Italian. As an adult, Timothy's knowledge of storm cells and tornadoes saved the Newbury Prep cheerleading squad. But when it came time to buy a new car, he was just as nervous as the rest of us. So Timothy got his knowledge at cars.com, regained his confidence, and got the perfect car at the perfect price.
My Toshiba laptop lets me crush it in the office, but if I say so myself, I do my best work at home.
Hey, loser.
I've gotten into digital photography, making videos.
Refund!
Really killer stuff.
Check, check.
I've also started work on a college football rock opera.
Running down the sidelines, on tiptoe, stay in bounds.
Give me a Toshiba laptop, and I'll give you magic.
Yeah!
Toshiba, leading innovation.
Is your computer running slowly? Thinking about buying a new one? Don't waste your money. Your computer could be infected with spyware, malware, viruses, or you could be experiencing registry errors, spam, and pop-ups. With new technology, you no longer need a technician to come to your home or drop your computer at some store. Get a free diagnosis at MaxMySpeed.com and find out in minutes what's slowing down your computer.
They were able to diagnose it and solve our problem. It's at least 100% to 150% quicker than before.
My computer runs twice as fast.
The computer has run so much quicker. It's safer, it's faster, it's more secure.
My computer is 100% faster than it was prior. All I could say is I'm a raving fan. This is unbelievable.
Go to MaxMySpeed.com right now for your free diagnosis and find out in minutes what's slowing down your computer. That's MaxMySpeed.com for your free diagnosis.
ESPN's College Football is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard, and in part by Toshiba. Toshiba, leading innovation.
Well, if you're anybody in Gainesville, you get your hair cut at Athletic Cuts. We should have sent Spielman over there, Greece. Four national champion football coaches, two national champion basketball coaches have gone to Athletic Cuts to get it trimmed. Here's Demps, and trying to get outside, can't. Good defense by Jordan Gafford, gain of about three. Early fourth quarter in Gainesville. First time Florida's played a game without Tim Tebow since 2005, and Gators' lead is only nine. Carradine, Miguel Carradine, Richard Sr. shaken up on special teams. Florida right now with 28 total yards. It's been 31 years since a Florida team had under 100 yards. That was against Alabama. And back in 1963, they were held to just 32 yards.
Look out.
They're going to get 32 on this play at least. The speedster, Jeffrey Demps, is gone. Touchdown, Florida. Total yards before that play, and Demps goes for 72 and a touch. Might be the fastest player in college football, Jeffrey Demps.
Well, speed kills.
Sturge is way off at a point after the 15-point Florida lead. Jeffrey Demps won the 2010 National Championship Outdoor Track 100-meter, 9.96 seconds, and look at him move here.
A couple of the offensive linemen, including the center, Pouncey, pulled and got out there and got a block. A shoot down the sideline for Jeffrey Demps, the fastest man in college.
And this is the indoor track championships, the 60-meter. Outruns everybody. Urban Meyer told us yesterday, guys, he's expecting big things out of Jeffrey Demps this year.
We also had the 4x100 national championship track team. And Chris Rainey was on it with Demps.
Quint has more on Demps.
Dave Urban said, you know, we like fast people around here, and certainly Demps is fast. As you guys said, 100-meter champion in the NCAAs. He wants to play in the NFL. That's goal number one. Goal number two would be the Olympics, and the next Olympic trials are in 2012. I talked to his track coach, Mike Holloway, before the game. I said, Mike, do you hold your breath every time he gets the ball? He says, no. He said, no. When he first got here, I did, but now I'm okay with him out there. And you could see as soon as he turned north-south, that one was over.
And guys, there are some that think that he is an underdog Heisman candidate going into the season.
With that speed, just get him the ball and let him go.
Running back wanted last year, Mark Ingram for Alabama. DeMarco Payne on the return for Miami. And he's out to the 30. Back to the studio now, Maurice Davis.
Dave, perhaps the most inspiring story of the day unfolding in Boston. Mark Herzlich, 2 years ago, the ACC Defensive Player of the Year, returning competition against Weber State. You see Herzlich all over the place and thrilled to be there. Missed the entire season a year ago with Ewing sarcoma, a form of cancer. Boston College has a lead on Weber State. And Georgia is cruising against Louisiana Lafayette, 41-7, just about to go to the fourth quarter between the hedges.
Yeah, Herzlich won the Comeback Player of the Year award before he even stepped on the field today, huh?
Yeah. It's a good story.
On the Miami 29. Dysart finds Robinson out to the 35-yard line. 8 of 6, the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series heads back south for Labor Day weekend. Only two races left. NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Atlanta tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN.
You know, if I'm Miami, I might start thinking about my 5-minute offense here. You've got 12 minutes and counting. You're down two possessions. You need to start upping the ante here a little bit. Get the speed, get the tempo.
We've had trouble enough getting the snap off without having to call timeout to avoid a delay of game penalty today. Big hole down the middle of the field for Tracy Woods. First down out near the 43. Miami won one game last year. They were 1-11, the worst offensive team arguably in college football, and they weren't much better on defense. So you got to give Mike Haywood and his staff a lot of credit getting this team mentally and physically prepared to come to Gainesville and play this well. Dicer dumping it off to Woods. Nowhere to run. Taken down 4 yards deep in the backfield, Matt Elam and Ronald Powell, two true freshmen.
What's that, a third true freshman in there, Dave? Also running was Sharif Floyd, big number 73. When you have true freshmen and they're playing at a key part of the game, that's a luxury that the Gators have that the Red Hawks don't have because of the depth. Big Sharif.
They think he's special. The number one defensive tackle prospect in the nation, Floyd from Philadelphia. Second and 14. Dysart with time. Now the pocket collapses, and so does Dysart. Ripped down by Jay Howard at the 35.
I thought the protection was okay, Grease. I think he's got to make a throw or make a decision.
You're right. The protection last year was really bad. They were worst in the country in protecting the passer. This time he had time to get rid of the ball or to pull it down and find a seam to get out of there.
Second sack of the day for Jay Howard. Dysart on 3rd and 18. Throws short to Woods. Taken down at the 38-yard line by Janoris Jenkins. And Miami will punt.
Hey, I like the true freshman coming up there and not shying away. Putting a little mano-a-mano against Brandon Hicks, the fine linebacker from Florida, but showing the guts, the psychological fortitude or whatever, Coach Haywood. In other words, put your head down and run his rear end over.
Rainey the deep man. Punts have been adventurous today. Penalty flag. They've kept us guessing up here whether it's going to be a punt or a fake.
Prior to the snap, false start, 18, offense, 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
8 penalties on Miami.
Miami has a huge advantage in time of possession, 31 minutes to 19 minutes for Florida.
Returnable. Rainey across the 30. Runs into his own man. And down at the 40-yard line. 8:47 left in the fourth. Florida 27, Miami, Ohio 12. Back in a moment to Gainesville.
Only 5 days left. Sign up at ESPN.com/fantasy.
See them boys? They got DirecTV. Been watching the Eagles game on their phones and laptops since they got here. No respect for their surroundings.
Ma'am?
Be right there, Shug. Here you go, fellas.
Only DirecTV lets you watch your game wherever you go. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Pizza Hut's new Big Italy pizza is big enough to satisfy even their appetites. If only Pizza Hut can do something about their free throw percentage.
Hey,
what?
The new Big Italy pizza with up to 3 of your favorite toppings is just $12. And for a limited time, get a free 2-liter Pepsi Max when you buy any 2-liter Pepsi. Only at your Pizza Hut.
Come into LensCrafters now and get 50% off lenses, including bifocals, no lines, and prescription sun at our semi-annual lens event. But after September 12th, this lens sale won't be back until next year. 50% off lenses. Another reason eyes love LensCrafters.
Momentum. It's like a rolling ball of thunder that takes on a character all its own. No one knows exactly how you get it, but once you have it, you drive like the devil to keep it. And tomorrow night, when momentum comes to town, it'll be harder than nails to stop.
The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Atlanta, tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN. Telecast presented by Pennzoil.
In Gainesville, the number 4 Florida Gators on top of Miami 27-12. It has not been easy, though, for Florida as Moody carries off right tackle for about 3 or 4 yards. Only 100 yards total offense for Florida so far. Coming up tonight, TCU and Oregon State. College football primetime presented by Hampton Hotels, part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week. Oregon State, last few years, has struggled in September games. TCU hoping that trend continues.
And their defensive trend of holding top running backs under 100 yards at TCU.
Here's Moody again. Flag down. And Moody to the 47-yard line for about 4. Deion Nunley on the stop.
A little holding here. And Pouncey.
Holding. Offense 55. 10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Long day for Mike Pouncey. Tonight on ABC, North Carolina takes on LSU. 13 players ineligible, including Marvin Austin, who has been suspended indefinitely. So the Tar Heels without 7 defensive starters. Any shot tonight for them? That depleted against LSU.
I think anytime. Yeah, you got a shot. I mean, was there any shot for Miami today?
A little bit, yeah. So there got to be a shot for North Carolina against LSU.
But I thought before all this stuff happened and they were suspended, it was going to be a great game. North Carolina with all those guys on defense.
Timeout, Florida. The first time out of the half.
But I really felt that that game tonight, with all those guys in, it was going to be a heck of a game. I still think Carolina can make a game of it.
Timeout, Florida. Back in a moment.
Sue, why are we hiding behind this display?
Shh. Not hiding. Hunting.
What are we hunting?
Quarterback.
Why are we only wearing Nike Pro Hyperstrong?
A hunter only brings what he needs for the hunt.
Nike Pro Combat Hyperstrong, available at Dick's Sporting Goods. Better athlete, better team.
About potential dangers, the world can be a far less threatening place. Take the scary out of life with Travelers Insurance and see the world in a different light.
Everybody believes in him a little bit, even guys like you who pretend they don't.
When he's near, there are no small accidents. There are no close calls.
What was that?
The worst always happens.
Something bit me.
Move out of the way!
Sometimes he can take human form.
Medic!
And torment the damned on Earth.
Turn on the lights!
Devil, rated PG-13.
I'm a Wrangler guy. Always have been, always will be.
Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans. For long-lasting comfort, the right choice is Wrangler.
Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
Hot and humid here in Gainesville, and Florida has really struggled offensively today. Just over 100 yards total offense, 72 coming on a run by Demps. Brantley goes downfield and caught in Miami territory by Omarius Hines, who the guy the coaches are very high on. Guys, back to what we were talking about prior to the break, North Carolina players, violation of team rules is what's being announced. There was also reports of illegal contact with agents, and something Urban Meyer has been very conscious of, closed practice during the fall to the media and also to agents to try to protect his players. Because obviously that's a big story right now in college football. Gillis Lee breaks a tackle and gets to about the 40.
You know, agents don't come on to the campus, to the locker rooms and onto the practice field to watch practice. But scouts do. They've allowed the NFL scouts to come on. So, you know, I think it's good when they had the phone call that they had, Nick Saban,
Jim Tressel.
Tressel and
Roger
Mack
Goodell
Brown,
also.
Mack Brown and Roger Goodell and Stoops, and they got some, you know, I think that's the right way to do it. And get the NFL Players Association involved, because there's got to be punishment on both sides. Now you punish the player, punish the agent.
Bradley again downfield. Hines can't come up with that. Third down.
Here's what I do. I collectively bargain, cover all my bases legally. Somehow, if I can go to a college and I can tell the kid at a college meeting, team meeting, hey, kid, if you take money from an agent, if you go to the NFL, you forfeit 50% of your signing bonus, plus you're suspended for the first 10 games. You become damaged goods. So a kid's going to be in a dark alley meeting a runner, and he's going to say, can I take this $5 or $10 grand now in his plane ticket, or should I wait? Because this is going to cost me about $10 million. That will help him make a decision. That's my opinion. That's what I would do to fix it.
Brantley with a ton of talk. An excellent catch for a first down by Deontay Thompson. Urban Meyer talked about the whole agent situation.
Well, a group of coaches got together, and then also you had some people on the other line that were the other end. At the end of the day, you don't have to be that smart to figure this out. There needs to be punishment on both ends, and then you eliminate the problem. Someone else came up with it. One of the other coaches on the line said, suspend the agent for a year. And I think that's brilliant. And same with a runner. You know, the runners, my kids have told me what goes on now.
First down, Myers Gators from the 32 of Miami. Gillislee ripped down out of bounds by Luke Kelly. Made of a couple.
By runners, Urban is referring to maybe a classmate of the star quarterback who knows the phone number or can get in touch with us. Hey, somebody wants to meet with you for lunch. Or maybe your roommate, maybe somebody in your dorm, somebody not on the team, maybe one of the kids of the secretary in the building, you know, whoever. That's what they refer to runners. You know, these runners you may know very well, and the agents get to them.
Inside handoff, and Rainey in trouble. And down he goes, back at the 37. Let's check in with Reese.
The rivalry opener day between Illinois and Missouri, getting late in the third quarter. This is Nathan Shieldhouse. He's a redshirt freshman quarterback running that Paul Petrino offense, the new offensive coordinator. A.J. Jenkins scores for Illinois, but Blaine Gabbert answers. T.J. Moe. Hey, Moe. Spread out. Touchdown, Mizzou. 13-10. Illinois has the lead.
Now back here, Reese, with Shemp and Curley. Third down and 15. And Brantley this time throws that one in the dirt.
Kim, I tell you how impressed I am with Miami's defense and her effort.
Uh-huh.
And I know back on the Miami campus, my niece, Allie Fitz, is watching this, and she's very proud of this defensive effort.
All right.
By coach and Carl Bull Reese and all the boys.
Another injured Florida Gator. It's been a long day in a lot of ways for the Gators. That's James Wilson, starting guard. Already Carl Johnson not playing because of a health issue. Xavier Nixon coming off a knee injury. He's expected back soon, but did not suit up today.
Matt Patchen, another offensive lineman who is in the mix in the top seven or eight, is out also with an injury.
Well, and injuries, I mean, they just come. There's really nothing you can do about them. You can't really prevent them. They just happen. And it's not a surprise that when injuries happen, Grease, you've been around this game a long time, player, coach, broadcaster, they come in bunches, and they're coming in bunches for Florida today. You just hope they're not too serious.
And they usually come at the same position.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the cornerback for Florida. Florida's had a couple of corners hurt yesterday or the other day and today.
Yeah, Moses Jenkins hurt earlier in the game. Jeremy Brown hurt in practice. Unsure whether he was going to play, but he did come into the game when Jenkins got hurt. Tonight on ABC, it's North Carolina with its forces depleted, taking on number 21 LSU. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines, part of Dick's Sporting Goods. Kickoff week on ABC. A lot of people talking about Rich Rodriguez being on the hot seat at Michigan. They're at 3:30 on ABC, taking on UConn. How about Les Miles? Guy just 3 years removed from a national title. Is his seat hot right now?
You're always hot in Louisiana. Yeah.
In the
at LSU.
Brantley throwing downfield on fourth down and 15, and it is caught for a first down by Omarius Hines.
Omarius having a good day. Making some big plays, turning third downs into first downs.
You know what kind of call that was? That was, we believe in you, John Brantley call. Make a play for us, JB.
This whole feeling today reminds me of a NFL preseason game where the offenses don't look good. They're sputtering. You have big plays on the defense. Punts, bad plays in the punting game.
Gillislee pounds his way to the seven, and he fumbled the ball, and Miami's got it. Deion Nunley recovering it for the Redhawks.
Lots of fumbles, interceptions.
Keep going.
This is like colleges do not play preseason games. The NFL, they do before they come out. So I'm sure that Urban's going to say, hey, that stunk. You know, next week is another game, and let's go.
Anthony Kokau coming up with a hit and a strip.
Yeah.
Double, daily double, whatever you want to call it. Look at that. Good hit, head up, bringing your feet, not quitting, stripping that ball out of there. Outstanding. Fundamental football.
Looked like
tackle.
It was out before Gillislee's knee hit the ground. I mean, the game's not over. It's still a two-possession game. And there's 4:47 left.
I was talking about the last series, Dave. Maybe they should have went with their five-minute offense. A little bit of a hurry-up.
Clock stop. They might further review this fumble by Gillisley. From our initial look, though, it appeared the ball was out before the knee hit.
The Florida head coach has called timeout to challenge the ruling of the field.
And in college, you get one challenge, and if you're correct, then you will retain that challenge to use it at a later time. If you lose the challenge, you lose the timeout.
When you think about them having trouble holding on to the football, you know where this doesn't stop here, because this game goes to that film room over there, that opponent's film room over there, that opponent's film room over there, and all of a sudden you're going to have defensive coordinators around the land saying, Florida can't hold on to the ball, boys. Come here and start stripping. They'll drop it. They'll put it on the deck.
And both coaches are going to have something to take away from this game.
Kokau, they're fighting good hit. Gillisley fighting for extra yards.
That ball's out. That's a fumble.
Yeah, it's a fumble. And on the Miami side, Urban is going to say, hey, we didn't play very well. We got South Florida come in here next week. He can use this game to get after him to play better. And on the other side, Mike Haywood, he says, hey, we played really well. Even though we lost, we may have lost. Let's go. We got two conference games in the next 2 weeks. Even though we were 1-11 last year, let's go play well. Take some good stuff for this game.
It looks like the ball is out.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Florida will be charged their second timeout.
You know, you talked about Florida's schedule. South Florida next, and Urban Meyer's team plays at Tennessee September 18th. They go to Alabama. They play Georgia, nearby Jacksonville. They go to Florida State at the end of the year. They do not play Arkansas. They do not play Auburn. Two seemingly upstart teams in the SEC. Now, Florida today doesn't look like a national championship contender, but they're going to be better.
Well, that's what Urban's got to sell. I mean, he's got to sell all these fans, say, hey, it's not as bad as it looks. Trust me, we'll be okay. And I certainly believe they will be okay.
Dicer finds Robinson. First down to the 27-yard line. Gain of about 14.
Again, an undersized offensive line for the Redhawks, doing an excellent job in protection because they know that the pass rush is coming. These guys aren't even honoring any run up front for the Gators.
Dicer to the air again, underneath again, and it's caught at the 35 by Rogers. What's your message if you're Urban Meyer to the young players? Remember, he said there's a lot of unknowns on this football team, especially in defense. He likes his freshmen, but they're still freshmen.
Well, didn't he have a message for some of the freshmen that, I don't know, whatever the issue was, they have no idea about what's about to hit them? Well, they have an idea about what's to hit them.
Dysert's pass off the mark downfield. Remember, Mike Pouncey came out and criticized some of the freshmen. He thought many of them felt they already had arrived before even playing a game at Florida. And he later backed off of those comments.
Well, that's a head coach's job to address that. Now, he can address it inside that locker room. Pouncey can address it inside the locker room. It's not his job to speak for the team about discipline of the team or other players' attitudes of the team. That's not his job. That's that man's job right there. Not his, the other guy. The guy without the blue shirt.
I don't think Pouncey will be saying much today anyway after the game. It's been a struggle for him. Third and two. And Dysert's pass caught despite a brutal hit. Ahmad Black even lost his helmet. DeMarco Payne on the grab. First down.
Yeah, DeMarco Payne better be careful. He pointed that first down, and sometimes you'll get a flag on that. He took a nice shot.
Hey, remember, there was a silly play down on the one-yard line by Armand Robinson on fourth down and goal that cost him 15 yards and maybe a touchdown. That call for unsportsmanlike. Pressure coming, and Dysert's pass intercepted by Jeremy Brown. That might do it here in Gainesville. Dysert should have thrown that one away.
Well, I think he was trying to throw it away or trying to complete it.
They're going
to
say it now that he was juggling it as he went out of bounds, so it's incomplete.
Let's take a look.
Really on the field, the player was juggling the ball as he went out of bounds. Therefore, the pass is incomplete.
Well, Miami's not done yet. Didn't look like a juggle to me.
Urban's already used his is a chance to review it.
But again, upstairs, every play is reviewed.
Yeah, previous play that's is true. Under further review.
That's true.
So and they had to see that right away.
Oh, for sure.
It's not a juggle. Dave,
yeah,
this
possession.
This is a great story about Brown and coming back from injuries.
Yeah, guy had the back problems, missed the last 2 years, and then this year hurt his ankle. You know, he was frustrated the other day when he hurt his ankle. Most people thought he was not going to play at all. Yeah, he gave it a shot, did not start, but he's been in there since Moses Jenkins went down.
And we saw him get hurt the other day.
Yeah.
He was on the ground. He was yelling and like he really knew it was a serious injury. He was down there for 10 minutes. The trainers came and helped him off. I didn't think there was any way he would play 2 days later.
A lot of that, a guy that's gone through traumatic injuries, you get hurt again in practice right before the game, the Thursday before the game. A lot of that's frustration. And the trainers do a good job. We don't know. Calm down, relax. But it's good if he gets this interception. Not good for the game or anything, just for the kid.
Yeah.
I mean, he's been through a tough time. Actually, Emmanuel Moody has helped him deal with all his injuries.
Yeah. He's a good kid, too.
And challenges that he's faced.
He's a good kid.
Yeah, Urban speaks the world of him.
Yeah.
After further review, replay shows that the defender did indeed intercept the ball. He's out of bounds at the 45-yard line. First down.
And so they get it right. They reverse the on-field ruling. Florida takes over. Third interception by Dysert. One was returned for a touchdown by Janoris Jenkins. Ahmad Black returned another inside the five, and then Jeremy Brown likely to seal victory. Check that, four interceptions for Dysert in the game.
You know, I know this doesn't sound right, but I just, if I'm Urban, I let Brantley throw the ball. I know that goes as unconventional, but I want to just keep getting him more reps and reps and reps.
Well, it's not like it's a 28-point lead. It's still a two-possession game. Gillis Lee with the cutback. Shaking would-be tacklers. They finally get him down around the 15-yard line.
Reese, that's the same play they scored the touchdown.
I was just going to say that. Same play, different running back, and almost the same result. Pouncey, 55, pulling from the center position, gets around, gets a block. Gillis Lee, the number three running back, just doesn't want to be tackled.
Well, we were told that Florida would feature its running backs more than in years past without the running quarterback in Tebow. Here's Gillis Lee again. And he gets drilled at the 13-yard line, but Jarrell Wedge. Well, you have Gillis Lee, a sophomore. You have Demps, a junior. We saw what he can do on that 72-yard scamper. And Emmanuel Moody, transfer from USC a few years back. He's a senior. They also have a true freshman, Mac Brown, they like at that tailback position. They moved Rainey, remember, from running back to the slot.
And in order for this team to be the number four ranked team in the country, they've got to have a running game involving running backs.
That has
to be a factor and a commitment to their part as the season progresses.
In the middle of this game, when they were really struggling last year, they would have just told Tebow to run the ball. Just take it and run it. And that gets him back on the keel.
Another horrible snap. Pouncey again low and outside. And back around the 25, covered up by Brantley. Wow.
That's the first thing. We can take everything else out. This is the other one. We can't throw in one hoppers back there.
See,
14 out of what? 40 snaps?
Well, see, he's moving. Before he completes the snap, he's moving to his right to make a block. You can do that if you're a guard, but if you got to snap the ball, first you got to make sure of the good snap to the quarterback, and then you step to the right or to the left or pull, as they've asked him to do, and go around and block.
Is it similar to a guy who can't throw from second base to first, or a guy who's got a three-foot putt that can't knock down?
I think he's thinking about it. Yeah, absolutely.
Brantley's pass deflected and nearly intercepted.
I just think he's moving before he completes the snap.
Especially when he's pulling. And when he runs that little sprint sweep out there, he's a good enough athlete and talented enough to pull from that position. But you're right, Bob, number one priority, first and foremost, snap the football.
C.J. Mark almost with the diving interception. Florida going for it. Fourth down and 21, though, from the 25. And Brantley in trouble, being chased. Throws it into the end zone, and it is caught on the redirection by Chris Rainey for a touchdown. That's one way to pick up fourth and 21.
But look at Irvin, though. I mean, his hands didn't come off his knees because he knows that that's lucky.
Yeah. That's right.
That's lucky. That's not execution.
That's not offense. And they'll tell him, hey, offense, that was luck, and we had a defensive score. Jenkins took an interception back, so you didn't score all these 34 points.
But what was he expecting? His fourth down and 21, you needed a miracle to convert that.
I say this, the quarterback did the right thing. Threw it up in the end zone.
Off the hands of Hines and into the awaiting arms of Chris Rainey. And here's what you're talking about. Guys, the reaction of Urban Meyer. He says, I'm still mad that we only got 200 yards total offense.
He knows that he doesn't want to score touchdowns like that.
It's almost like he's I'm not saying he's not. It's almost like he's disappointed.
It was a lucky play. We want to score touchdowns off of designed, executed, well-played plays. And that wasn't one.
Today's Discover Card player of the game, Janoris Jenkins, who had an interception return for a touchdown, also a handful of tackles in this game today.
It's a jackrabbit. It's a jackrabbit, Dave.
That's his nickname?
Yes.
So, guys, post-Tebow game one, Florida Gators, based on what you see out of Urban Meyer's squad, they're a national championship contender. Because you guys watch practice, you watch film of the spring game, so I know you're not basing your call just on what you saw today.
Well, they stunk today, but can they be good? Will they be good? They're well coached. They have talent. They're just young and inexperienced, and I believe they'll get it together. And toward the end, they absolutely have every chance to be in that hunt.
You with them, Bob?
To be continued. You know, this is not, we're not happy about this, but like I said, we have talent.
Payne across the 25 out to the 30 before he spun down.
I mean, that's the key. We have talent, just it's inexperience. You know, Brantley had never played at the start of the game. In time, yeah, this could be a good team.
The other thing is, it's not a bad thing to get your backside humbled. I mean, you've been humbled today. And that kind of refocuses everybody, players included. It's good to be humbled with a win as opposed to humbled with a loss.
There's no question Brantley has a ton of potential. That pass is dropped out in the flat by Robinson. And let's compare what Brantley did today to Tim Tebow's first start against Western Kentucky. 13 of 17, 300 yards and three scores for Tebow, but that was a regular Saturday afternoon for Tebow. How about Tebow's last game, Sugar Bowl, threw for over 400 yards against Cincinnati, 31 out of 35.
He's looking good in Denver, in my eyes.
So you think he can play at the NFL level?
Absolutely.
At quarterback. Roman Lawson on a carry gets a couple.
Okay.
You're in the minority. A lot of people think he can.
Well, you know, I've been that's kind of the story of my life, that if people disagree with me, but I don't care. Now, Bob might differ with me on it. I don't care what your delivery is, to be honest with you. As long as the ball's there and on time, I don't care how you can stand on your head and throw with your feet. I don't care.
He's a competitor. He's a winner. He's got it. You know, I don't care how he throws. I think that the team that drafted him has to, you know, drink a little bit of the Kool-Aid and change their offense a little bit to adjust to him. But the guy's got it. I mean, he may deliver. He may take a little bit bigger windup than normal, but, you know, he's won, and he's proven he can win.
Miami has trouble with the snap. Meanwhile, Florida's backup center, Sam Roby, doing a little work with John Brantley. But they're going to run the clock out here, and Florida is going to win this football game 34-12. Final score not indicative of how mightily Florida struggled with mistakes. Miami helped them. There are some bad plays, including a decision to fake a punt on their own 20-yard line that was costly. 34-12, the final score. Number four, Florida, wins in John Brantley's debut as the Gators' starting quarterback. College football scoreboard presented by Acura. Up next here on ESPN, for Bob Griese, Chris Spielman, Quint Gesnick, our entire crew. I'm Dave Pasch. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now let's send it to Reese, Mark, and Lou in the studio. Fellas,